So I advise you guys to go follow me on YouTube, because when I go up, it's over. So do I just get on your email list for the free stuff? Hold on real quick. I know some of you guys are going to ask, what am I making? I'm doing a meatloaf, quick and easy meatloaf. I got some red potatoes that are about to go bad. The ground beef's about to go bad. And I don't have TNT on my TV. excuse me. I guess TNT's not one of the channels that I picked for my package, pause, with the cable company. So I'm missing the All-Star game. I'm sure I could watch it on YouTube or IG or something, but I was like, let me just find something in here and cook it. And then, you know, I found you guys. I was like, oh my God, let me go with my friends. So YouTube in the building, what's good? YouTube and TikTok, my favorite family. Facebook is third. I'm sorry, any Facebook heads in here. I'm sorry, Facebook is third. So we're making a meatloaf. If you're trying to find out what to cook for dinner right now, go to your refrigerator. You have all this in your refrigerator, I'm telling you. Go get you some ground beef. If you don't have ground beef, my bad. Go get some ground pork. We're making meatloaf. Hello, bruh. What's up, bruh? Social Q's in the building. ASG. Oh, my God. ASG is garbage. All-Star getting garbage? Oh, okay, bet. Bet. I thought ASG was like some code, so I had to look at it real close. So go get you some. We're making a meatloaf. Everything you should have. Go get y'all some ground beef. Hurry up. Hurry up. We can't play no music because, you know, I won't be able to monetize on YouTube. So there's no music here, people. No music, people. Just good old my voice and you. My voice in the comments. Let me get some water. Meatloaf, go get you some ground beef. Why are you screaming? I don't know, because I think y'all can't hear me. My bad. If I'm screaming, turn your phone down, fat head ass. No, I'm just playing. That's all we need. Where the comments? Y'all not? Can I not see them, or are you just not commenting over here on YouTube, fraud? shout out to all the replayers on YouTube. Hit that subscribe button. Comment if you want to comment. Like it all the time. And share it to your homies and your mom and your dad and your grandpa and everybody else. All the replayers. Everybody that's here in the live, you fraud for not commenting. TikTok, what's good over here? TikTok, you don't look. Look. I ain't even give TikTok no speech. And then look at they over here sending gifts. And what you doing, YouTube? I might have to rethink about going live on YouTube. What happened? Oh, shout out to TikTok sending the gifts. Who was that? Is that Vanita? Two VIP coach. I think that's Vanita's page, though. It don't say Vanita. It says two VIP coach. All right. Come on, y'all. All right. We're doing a meatloaf. All right. I got 2 pounds of ground beef on your head top. Okay. With a meatloaf, you want what? Usually, you know, what I cook, most of y'all know. Usually when you have a meatloaf, a lot of people might what? Mix it with what? Pork. But some people don't eat pork. So what do? Ground beef, but what kind? Oh, I'm going to get the 7327. Nope. That's why your meatloaf trash. That's why you came here right now. You ain't had nothing else to do. And you got to go to work tomorrow. But tomorrow's Sunday. You got to go to work tomorrow because we all struggling. And, you know, I'm just trying to tell you what it is. And it was on sale. If it ain't 80/20 and above, you're fraud. Your meatloaf, that's why your meatloaf trash. Your family don't even want you to cook it. You're like, I don't like meatloaf. No, your meatloaf's trash. You don't like cooking it because you don't like the way it comes out. That's why you're here. All right? 2 pounds of 80/20 ground beef. TikTok over here. Now YouTube here. Oh, my God. Hey, eventually when I get 4 phones. Oh, my God. Okay, so with the ground beef, I'm going to just... You know, guys, y'all know what this is. I'm just trying to, you know, everybody make meatloaf, but we might not make it the same way. That's all this is. It ain't nothing major. I'm not doing anything you can't do, but what if? What if there's somebody out there that ain't never had meatloaf a day in their life? Today's the day, Craig. Today the day, Craig. We got 2 pounds of ground beef in the bowl. What's next? Huh? Since everybody's smart, what we putting next in the bowl? You tell me. Put it in the comments. What I'm putting next in the bowl? Since all y'all moms and dads and y'all cooking and stuff, everybody clean. Y'all act like y'all just don't mess up in the kitchen. What's next is going in the bowl? Or what would y'all put in next? Egg, bread, crumbs. Wrong. Eggs. Onion. Oh, Vanita. Vanita, you are the winner. Hit up my Cash App. I might send you something next year because I am broke. But we'll put your gift on layaway. That's what we can do. No. I got all these products. Vanita. Oh, my God. Email me your email and I'll get you a gift ASAP. Okay, Vanita's right. We're going to do onion. Now, a lot of people... Okay, this is why I'm going to tell you don't do egg. You want me to tell you why? Other than your fraud, you don't do egg because what if you do cook the onions in the skillet? The onions and the bell peppers to bring out the flavor, to sweat the flavor. What if you do cook that and you're going to put it on top of eggs and cook the egg? That's why your meatloaf sucks. I told you. This is why y'all don't make meatloaf. You're putting your egg first. Me and Vanita need to throw a party. You need to come over. Y'all throwing your egg first? So we're eating scrambled meatloaf. Come on, guys, stop. We're not here for this. We just want to eat the meat and loaf. We ain't trying to eat the meatloaf and egg scramble. Breakfast meatloaf? Okay, bet. Now, this is another thing. This is... Nobody want to eat a meatloaf and you crunch an onion. It's like you crunch it on the back of a knife. Nobody... Come on. That's why people put it on the skillet. A lot of people cook it because they don't want the crunch. Nobody want to break their teeth when they just trying to eat a meatloaf. So what I did was you can grind it up. Right? You know, guys, I got to talk slow because some of y'all are, oh, man. You can grind it up. Look how small I got. This look like I ground up some. I did it with my fingers. Oh, chill. YouTube. I'm trying to monetize, so I can't go too crazy. I'm on YouTube over here. Y'all go watch me on YouTube. If you don't follow me on YouTube, TikTok, you're fraud. And you're going to miss out on everything because if we're going to change the world, you're going to miss out. Small onions, small bell peppers. If it's bigger than a baby tooth, your food gonna be trash. Let's go ahead and dump that in the bowl. And don't be scared to do it. Because you're cutting them so small, you don't have to cook them. You know what I mean? Because it's gonna cook in the oven almost an hour. Chill out. Y'all wanna do too much. Like, y'all be so fraught. Like, y'all be really fraught. Like, y'all wanna do so much in the kitchen. Oh my God, let me pull out the skillet and saute. Come on. We're sick of it. I appreciate the comments and the gifts. YouTube, what's up? All the replayers on YouTube. If you don't follow me, you're fraud. Okay, so we have ground beef, onion, and pepper. I'm going to hurry up. What's next? Vanita won. Vanita got whatever she want. What the goes in this bowl next? But if it's your recipe, you're going to be right about everything. Exactly. What goes next in the bowl? It's my recipe. Stop. Oh my God, it's fine. Come on. Look, everybody on YouTube, y'all slow. Look, YouTube, it's 121. YouTube, what you doing with 121? I thought it said 21. I didn't see the one. Whoa. My bad. Hey, TikTok. She bought me a Birkin. Hey, what's up, YouTube? What you doing? Hey, my bad, YouTube. Where we at? The official golden line. What's good? Make chicken nuggets. Oh, yeah, you fraud. TikTok, my bad. It's little kids over here. I don't know what they doing over there. Ritz. What we making? Oh, who said that? Seasoning. Oh, seasoning's good. Actually, you know what? That's a good call. I'm frauding you. You could put seasoning. So seasoning's not wrong. It's not wrong. Okay? But what goes next is... Damn, a lot of y'all answered. Ava said Ritz next. She's actually correct. It's not Ritz, though. You could use Ritz. You can use Ritz. And what you want is about a cup. About a 3/4 of a cup or a cup of breadcrumbs. I've seen people do oatmeal. What do you put in y'all's meatloaf? Have you ever seen people put oatmeal in here? I've seen oatmeal. No lie. I've seen somebody put oatmeal in their freaking meatloaf, in their meatballs and stuff. And you want to do, like I said, about a cup. I'm going to do 3/4 of a cup because I don't trust it. You know, so I'm going to do it. 3/4 of a cup. 3/4 of a cup of breadcrumbs, please. Hello, Dad. Hello, Choppy. Ava, you're the winner. Well, I can't wait till I, these sponsors give me cash, and I can't wait till we like build up the donations and stuff, and I go live and y'all get the stuff and y'all win, and I just send you $1,000 in your bank account because we can do it then, you know, little stuff like that. So YouTube, again, make sure y'all go to bewoodcooks.com, donate if you can. If you can't, it's okay. Go to the email list and sign up for free. That's YouTube. I'm live on TikTok and TikTok. I'm on YouTube. Stop. I should be on all four. Facebook, I should be on all of them. But I don't have a whole bunch of phones. But if you donate, I can get a whole bunch of phones. Stop playing. And I can have an assistant. Oh, what if I had an assistant passing me stuff? I can hurry up, but I don't. So, donate. I'm going to do 3/4. Again, you can do a cup. You can do a cup of breadcrumbs, a cup of Ritz crackers. I've seen people do oatmeal. In my original, my first meatloaf video that I've done, I did wet bread. You can do that. But we're going to go... seasoned breadcrumb vibes. That's what we're doing. We're going to put that in a bowl. So, Ava, you're the winner of a layaway gift. hey, I got you. Hey, the layaway gifts, I got you. I can promise layaway gifts. What's up? Just give me 5 years. I got you. Again, I'm doing three quarters. What's 3/4? 75.75, 3/4. I'll be your assistant. Vanita, come on. Vanita, you already said you're in Dallas-Fort Worth and you're looking for a part-time job. You said that a couple lives ago. I don't forget anything. Again, Vanita, you're a day one. I just want to do it correct. I don't want to put somebody involved and I'm not right. You know what I mean? Because at that point, the second I put somebody on my team, I'm affecting their life. I can't waste their time. Because they could be using that time and using that energy for something else. We got to do it right. Oh, this is water, by the way. I'm just turned up. I told you I turned ADHD when I talk to my followers. It's real life. I love it. What's next? I got the breadcrumbs. So we got the beef. We got the onions and the bell peppers. You can cook it if you want to, but some of y'all are fraud and you don't have enough time. So you're really not fraud. This is just a word that I use. I'm fraud. You're not. Okay. So we have the breadcrumbs. What's next? What's next? It's my recipe, but what's next? I want to know what's next. I need to give YouTube love. My bad, TikTok. YouTube, eat a baked bean. YouTube, y'all kind of weird. What's up, y'all good? What happened? What happened, YouTube? What we cooking? We're doing meatloaf, YouTube. Tina Shaw on the building. Let's go. Hey, from Cali. Okay, bro, I have a lot of followers from Cali. My demographics is Houston, New York. They didn't tell me the city. They just said New York. So what's up, New York? What's up? Houston, New York, Dallas, Fort Worth, of course. In Cali, for sure. Like the whole state. They didn't even say like the city. They just said the state. So shout out to Cali. A lot of my GastroPass products is from Cali. Shout out to Cali. The love is real. When I come up there, take care of me. Clear throat. I'm a grown man. Garlic. Oh, no. Garlic. Garlic's part of the seasoning. No. Cook it up, brother. Jason Thompson with the support. What's good? I just got in. What's on the menu? Meatloaf, and we're going to do like a meatloaf meal. If you can't see it on the title, reread it. And if it's not there, shout out to YouTube for frauding me. TikTok, where you at? Brittany, Kansas City here. Memphis, Georgia. Okay, Georgia. Spices, egg, spices, egg. No. Everybody's no. This is tricky. This is a tricky question. What goes next in a bowl? This is tricky. I'm sorry, guys. I should just blow my nose. Sorry. What goes next in the bowl? Come on. Use your brain. We have the ground beef. Okay? Replayers, I appreciate you. People that are live, I appreciate you. All the donors, I appreciate you. Go to bewoodcooks.com. Who is this? Eminem. Eminem said milk. That's it. Eminem said milk. That's it. Let me go get my, I want to get another, thing. Where is my third? Oh, Armand, are you here? I'm already using it. Eminem said milk. Milk is correct. I got you a layaway prize on layaway. You can use any milk. We can go. You know, I've never used heavy cream. The milk is just a, it's like a, just in case I don't make it home tonight. Because you don't want it dry. So just in case it gets dry, you put a little milk in there. You know what I mean? You can do 2%, 1% skim milk, almond milk, garlic milk, lemon pepper milk. You can do all the milks. Just do, damn, this is, I knew I didn't have it. I was like, man, I already have it out. Fourth cup. Where is my third cup? This is my half cup. You want a third cup of milk. You could do a half cup. I should have just went ahead and did it. But you could do a half cup. But we're going to do a third cup of milk. What's next, Craig? What's next? You're not going to know this one, but I'm going to add a little W sauce. Wash your sister sauce. We're going to add some of that. This is not the what's next guess. This is not it. I'm just doing this so we can speed it up. I'm going to add a little W sauce in here. But what's after what I'm about to add? We're going to add a little ketchup. Charles, your lunch is ready. Put a little ketchup in there. We'll put a little bit more in there. We ain't playing. We need the moisture. What is next? Please tell me. Charles. Oh, please tell me, please. Charles, your lunch is ready. Hey, that boy. Oh, they. Charles, your lunch is ready. Yeah. Hey. Miss Nett, or whatever. I can't remember the name. I love her. She go hard. She funny. Milk is there to help keep it juicy. Juicy, baby. Much success to you. Shout out to YouTube over here. All the replayers, shout out to you. Make sure you subscribe. If you don't, you're fraud. Milk. Make it moist. Yeah, I said it first. User, no. User, I saw you say it, but Eminem said it first, user. I promise you. Bro, can scroll up. An egg and raw is crazy. Yeah, raw, yeah. We need the moisture. You already know that. Why are you singing that? I can't. Oh, Mr. Netta. Miss Netta. Yeah, okay. So what is next? We have the onions, we got the onions, the bell peppers, the ground beef, the ketchup, the breadcrumbs, the milk. What's next? Milk is there to help keep it juicy. Facts. What's next? And I'm really just going through the steps. It's like a thing where you keep repeating it, then you'll always remember. Because it's really easy, guys. Like, when you want to do something like this, like if I wasn't talking and doing a video or something like that, we can do this in 10 minutes. Not even, you know what I mean? And then you can have your meal, put it in the oven, make your sides. You should be done in an hour. And you're sitting there. I used to see my mom do this all the time. Like, she used to watch the Judge Judy, hit this, put it in the oven, watch Judge Judy, had potatoes going, green beans, and it is ready to rock. You know what I mean? So I've seen this my whole life. this is, I could do this in my sleep. I'm guessing I could sell CDs. I'm not a businessman. I'm a businessman. So let me, seasonings. That is correct. Did you put in the seasonings? Caramel drip is correct. My mom the same way, 100%. Why are you making meatloaf at 10 p.m.? I'm in Texas. I'm located in Texas, so it's 8:37. Which is fine. That is a valid question. I'm just making it to go live. I know a lot of people, especially on Saturday night, is on their phone at nighttime. I know you just asked some questions, so I'm just answering. Okay, that's what I'm making tomorrow. Let's go tomorrow. Egg. Seasonings is correct. Nuskies. Go check them out. Nuxies. I just did a video on them. Nuxies. N-U-K-S-Y-S. I did say it's mid, but mid don't mean bad. So I think the flavor, believe it or not, this flavor would be good in this bowl. Check them out. N, as in Nancy, U as in umbrella, K as in kite. K, kite. Yeah, that's right. S as in Sam, Y as in yellow, and then S as in Sam. Nuxies.com. They're not paying me for this. They just sent me this on Gastro Pass, and I got the seasoning. It's actually pretty decent. So we're going to put a little bit in there. It's like a, this is a veggie spice, and it's vegan. I mean, it don't matter because I'm putting other stuff that's not vegan, but it's a veggie spice, so it has all your, like, you know, your overall, you know, your flavors, man. It's almost like a vegetable broth, like I said. Imagine like a dry vegetable broth with like some spices to it. Add you a little bit in there. And I'm only doing a little bit. It also got like some little flakes in there. We're going to thug it out with some garlic powder. What's my favorite seasoning? Garlic powder. I can hear the crowd saying it now. Stop playing with me. I can see the future. Okay. We need the garlic powder, don't we? Of course we do. I want to do another brand that sent me some products. I told you this is one of my favorite seasonings. Bayou Crown. Bayou Crown. I don't know if he has a website. Maybe he does. He wanted to send me some other stuff. I didn't. I said send it, but I don't know if he sent it. I don't know. But this is one of the brands. Like, say if I did my Gasser Pass on the road, I would just hit him up and ask him to, because I believe in this product. I don't know if he has a website. I don't know if he has all this stuff ready, but I can use my resources with my audience. I know how to build websites. I know how to get that done. I know how to use AI. I can use a little bit of cash flow. I know how to make videos, all that stuff. So I would hit him up, travel to him, try to change his mind, try to help him with social media and what I can help be his puzzle piece, and we'll take over the world. It's just a little simple stuff like that. Again, you know, I truly believe in business. I'm a low-key entrepreneur. I really believe in business. Because I believe that with business, you open up a business, you can affect other people who then can affect other people who then can affect other people. You know what I mean? So that's the easy way to make change. Only way to make change is if you make change. All right. So them two, Bayou Crown and Nuxies, go check them out. Bayou Crown. They're on Facebook, I think, and TikTok and Amazon. Nuxies. All the replayers, shout out. They're not paying me, but it's cool. They'll pay me eventually. We're going to add just... I know it's a lot of seasoning, but it's really not. You can't really over-season... You can't really over-season meatloaf. I would rather add as much seasonings as I can and go from there. You know what I mean? You do have the sauce, but that's fine. And I'm really not adding that much. It looks like I'm pouring a lot, but I'm only putting like maybe a teaspoon, two teaspoons. Just a pinch of chicken bouillon just to make sure that it's there. You know this is one of my favorite seasonings. And then we're going to backdoor it with some pepper. The pepper you're really not going to taste, but it's here. So it is my grandma's favorite seasoning. So we're going to use some pepper. I'm making a meatloaf. Okay. So we got 2 pounds of ground beef. We got our seasonings, right? Well, let's go in order. We got 2 pounds of ground beef. We got our onions and our bell pepper. We got our breadcrumbs. We got our milk. We got our ketchup and all that other stuff. And then we got our seasoning. Okay? We're making a meatloaf. This should be easy for you guys. Oh, and we put some milk in there. Milk is just a... make sure the moisture's there. I don't know why I did that. That was stupid. That's cold, isn't it? That's not sign language for moisture. Maybe this is. Stop! I need to monetize. So, let's wash our hands. I wish I had gloves. Normally I have gloves, but I don't. Shout out to TikTok, all the people that sent badges. Where am I at? 6,000 likes. Let's get the likes up. I normally don't ask for that, but now I have to. I'm at 6,000 likes. Let's try to get that up. And then 16 people over here watching. Let's try to get that up. Share it to your mom's side piece or your dad's side piece. Share it to them because they're the ones that's going to, you know, they got a lot on their back. And, you know, they'll do anything that person says. So just share it to them. Share it to your parents' side piece. All right. Oh. Use your hands. Now, this is the time where y'all are like, oh, why do you TikTok chefs and Instagram chefs, why do y'all be using gloves? For this time. But I don't have it. So we're going to mix it up with your hands. Okay. We don't have to go too crazy. I think that's one thing that's a misconception. Oh, my God. I'm just, when I go live, I use the biggest words ever. Misconception? I'm on a freaking roll. Vroom. This is great. I need to go live every day then. So mix it up with your hands. You don't have to go crazy. That's what I think people miss that with meatloaf. Only reason why I know I'm sounding great and smart. Only reason why I know that is because Food Channel. Like my mom used to watch Food Channel too, and I just seen it over time. And I seen her do it. I just seen them do it. So this is, you know what I mean? It's not something that I know. I just seen them do it. They were like my college. You know, if you go to school for culinary arts. So we'll say don't flip it no more than 10 times. You know, this is probably my 10th time right here. Okay. What's next? What's next? Girl, you seem to love me now. Woo! Would you love me if I was down and out? Would you still have love for me? Girl, you seem to love me now. Ooh! Would you love me if I was down and out? Would you have love for me? If I didn't smell so good, would you still love me? Good. Where's my, oh. This woman's worth, this woman's worth. Oh, 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 my bad. I'll just let y'all know I have vocals too. You young folks, y'all might not know what that is. Go watch you some love and basketball. Should be crying. What's next? I took you to the candy shop. Bow, 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 bow. He's like, you say, what's next? Should be in. Teacher with the vote. Eminem crazy. Yep. I'm going to stop. All right, I'm yapping a lot. I'm going to stop. What you know about Jay-Z? Whoa. Jay-Z's my favorite rapper. Y'all chill out. Don't do that. Don't speak like that, please. Y'all don't do that, please. Jay-Z is my favorite rapper. Y'all don't ever disrespect. I know you ain't disrespect. I'm just saying y'all don't mention his name. What's next? What's next? Come on. Oh, eggs. Who said that? Cassandra, you are correct. Cassandra. Okay. This is good. This is how you do this. For every 1 pound of ground beef, you're going to add 1 egg. You got it? For every 1 pound of ground beef in a meatloaf, you're going to add 1 egg. Did you know that? I'm dropping them gems. Ooh! H-O-V-A. I got my mojo back, baby. Oh, behave. No, no. Don't be afraid. Y'all in your articles, hard spit at Jay. Woo! That's blueprint 2. What you thought? I would not have nothing to say. Nope. You fell into the booby trap. I set the trap just to see dude react. And now, come on, man. This is what I do. And I'm sorry, Miss Rosie Perez. I call a spade a spade. It just is what it is. Oh, y'all chill out. My bad. And you sound a little naive in the articles that I read. Now, you remember how we just add seasonings? Damn, bro, chill. Hey, handsome. Okay, oh, man, God. With the, this basic 101 cooking dog. Oh, you know. Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah. Basic. You got to stop, gang. You break a window. Hey, chill out. Why are you over here trying to hot side, my boy? Chill out. Let's add a little bit of salt. I know I already add seasonings, but this is, I told y'all, one thing about meatloaf, you're not adding enough seasoning because you think, oh my God, I put 2 teaspoons of each thing. Lucy, Bethel, Uncle Sam's wife, who else? Roseanne, Roxanne, whoever, Karen, it's not enough. It's not enough. We need more salt and pepper. At least this. And you don't have to go crazy with all of them, But at least salt and pepper. You know what I mean? That. That. Ooh, baby, babe. Top it off with salt and pepper, and then you're going to get nasty with it. This one, we're probably going to toss it, what? No more than 10 times. Because you don't want to beat the hell out of it. You know what I mean? I would say beat the thing, but I'm trying to monetize on... I could say beat the ground beef. But I want to say the other way, but I'm trying to monetize on YouTube. Shout out to YouTube. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you leave a comment. Share it. I know y'all being petty and counting right now. I already know. Make sure you subscribe and you share it. Comment. Do all that stuff, YouTube. I appreciate everybody being here, sending badges, all that good stuff. Go to bewoodcooks.com, donate. I'm going to update it with recipes that are nowhere else eventually. I just been busy, bro. Chill out. You know what I mean? That's the only reason why I don't be, Yeah, you're going to have to hit this. This egg, it don't want to mix. It's not like them, back in the day, the eggs hit different. These eggs don't want to be breaking down. It's like the yolk stiff. It's standing, how the yolk standing on business? Like, what? What the yolk standing on business for? We're just trying to fold you in there. Damn. The yolking. Let me find out. Because you got to get it mixed in there. So we're going to have to hit it more than 10 times. All the replayer. Oh, you're fraud. I know you're going to hit me in the comments. Oh, look, see? He messed up. He sucks. I'm sorry. You might have to hit it 20 times. Because it's still yellow. It shouldn't be yellow. It should just be in... There it is right there. So about 15 to... Boom. There it is. That's what you want right there. That's what you want. That's what you want right there. That's what you want, babe. Hey, Charles. Lunch almost ready. See. All right, baby. Oh. That Gouda and herb does sound good, though. Oh, yeah. You could put cheese in here, too, if you want to, guys. Like blue cheese, Gouda, Parmesan you can put in here. Any cheese. You can put sharp cheddar cheese in here. Do whatever you want. I see everybody else do it. What's the difference? Okay. A lot of you don't have. You know what? One thing that a lot of people don't have, but we should have, and I don't even have it, is a rack. Actually, I do have a rack. We need to have racks because for stuff like this, I could have put it on a cookie sheet, put a little rack so it can drain all the juice and be, you know, the texture that we want it. Because some people don't mind it sitting in the juice because you can drain the juices out or do whatever you need to do. But a lot of people put on cookie sheets. They'll use parchment paper. We're just doing a good old loaf pan that I use for all my bread recipes. Okay. Where are you selling it? I don't sell it. I'm not into selling products. I'm into investing in food companies. We're not here to sell products. Y'all have products and we're going to sell your products. But you're ignoring YouTube live chat. No, I'm not ignoring. I'm just paying attention to what's the name over here. TikTok. Go to TikTok. I'll read all your stuff. TikTok really talking over here. Y'all over here. Y'all sound like y'all at church over here. Silent face, man. You have it, you know, and a lot of people that cook don't even be talking in comments, so chill out. Spray it with some baking spray, just a little bit. Not a lot, baby girl. Just a little bit. A lot of people use non-stick. But I use baking spray. And I can't say bacon. Bacon. I always say bacon because I get some country. But... baking spray. I'm messing with you. I know. I'm just messing with you. Dang, drip. You're good fake fate. I don't know. Sorry about that. I should have added you. At least you got leftover facts. A lot of this is going for lunch. I have lunch the next 2 days. Music tastes valid. Season it till you see it. You know what I mean? A lot of people say season it until you, you're going to season it until you, what's the word? Sneeze. That Texas twang, I hear you. YouTube in the building. So, get you a loaf pan. Okay. I'm going to do it back here so you can see it. Actually, no. We'll just go like this. Get you a loaf pan, and we already sprayed it, and just put globs. Globs, just like this. That's it. Remember, the key is the reason why you don't want to shape it, and I'm going to tell you why you don't want to like really shape it and mold it, is because when you leave pockets, it helps it cook. It helps it breathe. That's my personal opinion. You know what I mean? It's like when you cook a burger and you put holes in it to check. It's the same concept. So you just want globs. Glob it up, baby. Just glob. That's it. You just want to let it. You want pockets in there. A lot of people say, oh, no pockets. I'm like, well, you want a little bit of pockets. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. You don't have to go crazy. And then if you have leftover ground beef, just use it for meatballs the next day. If you have leftover ground beef, wrap it in saran wrap or put it in a Ziploc or whatever you're going to do. And then use it for ground beef, make you a gravy, and then you have Salisbury steak or hamburger steak, whatever you want to call it. You can just fry it up like a burger. So literally take this, fry it up like a burger, put some gravy on top, serve it with mashed potatoes. You got dinner the next day. Mom, it's the same thing. Shut up and eat that food. Just like that. That's how you do that. That's how you do that. All right. And another thing, the reason why I do the bacon spray, the baking spray is because, say if you want to take it off the loaf pan, you want to take it out of there, it just slides out of there. A lot of y'all know about that. Chill out. A lot of y'all need to get y'all some loaf pans. You feel me? That's the problem. That's why a lot of y'all be arguing. What you arguing for? Argue. Okay. Charles, it's almost ready. We almost ready. I'm just trying to form it so it look decent. That's it. My mom used to do it just like this. We gonna form it there, baby. We're doing meatloaf. Anybody want some meatloaf? So you see this extra right here? I could literally probably Tuesday when I run out of this, because I won't be tired of it because it's... I would do a hamburger steak, and it's going to be like seasoned and stuff like that, just marinating in the refrigerator. Shout out to YouTube. How we just get 89 out of nowhere, YouTube? Y'all be frauding with the view. YouTube, how you go from 9 to 89 people like that? What happened? What, y'all put me in a whole nother country? What happened? What's up? I can't speak different. Now we at 171. Man, they fraud over here. YouTube, what's up, man? Yeah. Talking about 171 people over there. You go from 9 to 171. All right. Let me make you. We're going to make our rounds. Okay. Look at that right there. Don't she look pretty? Do you believe in magic? I was swiping and you popped up. Ish, I'm with it. What's up, baby? I can't really cuss that much because I'm trying to monetize. But if I wasn't trying to monetize, I'll be cussing every second. Trust me. I should throw out the F word right now to just let you know I'm team cuss word. I don't care what they're talking about. I'm a firm believer in Christ, but there ain't no way they weren't saying cuss words in the Bible. Come on. That's why he said don't say it. That's why he said don't say it right there. He said don't say it because they were saying cuss word every second. Jesus, like, bro, come on. These boys are walking 40 miles. You can't say they weren't saying a cuss word. Jesus, what is this shit? Come on. What is this? What is this? Jesus, like, hey, we got to do what we got to do for God, Father God. Jesus, I don't understand. What is this? All right. Oven set on 400. Everybody, okay, again. If you never know what to put it on 300. I don't have a thermostat. That's one thing I do need. I do need thermostat. You know, that's another thing that I'm noticing with gas or pass. I haven't touched a lot of businesses. But we need to start thinking outside the box. And that's why I said I'm glad that I'm doing what I'm doing. Make sure you go to bewithcuz.com. Donate. Sign up on the email list if you want free stuff. Donating is not free, but please do it now. It's because a lot of people are sending me, like I said, the cliche stuff, which is fine. I mean, at least they have a business. I'm not saying nothing. They have something I don't have. This is some of my GastroPass brands. They got it. I'm talking all this hot mess and I ain't even got a business. I got Be With Cooks only. So let me, you know, So this is not none of that. But what I'm noticing is, maybe I know the cost of goods, the startup cost would be a lot, but why don't, there's not a lot of businesses that are like trying to attack other things, like a thermostat. Like, you know what I mean? Like knives and kitchen accessories. Like there's seasonings, but one thing I like about Nuxie's seasonings is because it's a vegan, gluten-free seasoning. Let's start attacking the let me give you an example. Beyonce and the country music. Let's start being Beyonce and country music, people. This is not a color thing. I'm talking about everybody. Let's start being white people. Let's start making macaroni and cheese baked in an oven. Why, it ain't got to be Velveeta. It don't have to be. Oh, man. We don't... let's start baking it. Black people, come on. Let's start making country songs. Let's be unity. Let's start making donuts. Asians, start... No, Asians, they out here. Asians frying chicken, Kool-Aid, gas. Asians doing nails, boy, weave game... crazy. Hey, they all the product. Where is this from? China. Guys, China out here. Asia out here. Hey, Asia, my bad. Hey, Asia, you're excluded. My bad. All the Asian community, China. Hey, you got it. Hey, we got to catch up. My bad. But yeah, everything, we trying to catch up to them. But yeah, we got to, come on. Let's put it in the oven 400. We're going to do it. I think they say internal temp should be, damn, I said internal. That's a big word. We should probably put it in the oven. I don't have a thermostat, so I'll say about an hour. And then the temp should be 175, 170, you know? I'm guessing. Hey, I'm guessing. 175, I need to get a thermostat. Anybody that has a product, if you sell kitchen gadgets like thermostats, what, is it a thermostat? Is it a thermostat? Whoa, am I missing something here? Hold on, man. Hold on. Is it called a thermostat? Hey, I said be with cooks, not be with chefs. Y'all got to give me some... Oh, you're supposed to know this, not us. Hey, y'all better chill out with all that. I'll fire you up in the comments. Let me shout out to YouTube and I get to TikTok the real family over here. TikTok the real community, the people that have been supporting me the most, TikTok. I got my day ones over there. I got my mom, Danny D, she over there. That's my real family. I'll get y'all in here in a little bit. Let me tend to them newbies. I'm sorry, TikTok. Turkin Issen is in the building. What's up, my boy? Barbecue with Neil. It looks amazing, my friend. I bet you'll taste even better. Whoa. Whoa. I'm trying to monetize YouTube. Not trying to demonetize. You're making comfort food. You can guarantee people are going to show up 100%. 100% faith. Yeah, they're going to show up, man. Well, I believe anyway. Even if somebody don't show up, I still believe. I don't believe in failure. So even if y'all don't show up, I'm just looking for why didn't they show up so I can go get them to show up. I never lose. That's why I say y'all donate and believe in me because I never lose. Nothing stopped me. I'm all the way up like that. New algorithm with vertical streaming. Oh, you're dropping dimes. Oh, you dropping dimes. Hold on. Let me YouTube. I'm sorry. I'll be back. Jason Thompson, yo, this 500 from your baby. What? What we cooking? Meatloaf? Hey, from Cali. Okay, I read that. Eat at Baked Ham. Detroit from here. Okay. Tallahassee, Florida is in the building. Seattle, Washington in the building. Eggs. We're about to do mashed potatoes, and we're about to do... I don't know why y'all be sleeping on frozen vegetables. Put them in the microwave, put butter and garlic powder, and call it a day. Come on. What are we doing? Just put some butter, garlic powder, and some sea salt on there, and just go tell them to sit down and shut up. You're cooking for your family anyway. Tell them to sit down, shut up. Eat this. It got flavor. You know, put some flavor on there. Hold on. Let me do more YouTube. I'll be right back. TikTok. Imagine TikTok right now. Imagine like we're at a dinner table. We're all hanging out. And I go to the bathroom for a long time. That's it. Ketchup, brown sugar while baking. Yeah, I do. Okay, so what I do is for the sauce, I probably cook it. 45 minutes into it, I'll take it out, put some sauce on top, and cook it all the way through. So eventually, I think what I'm going to do now is make the sauce in front of you guys, which is cool. You put what I'm about to basically put in there. It's a simple sauce. We just showed you how to do meatloaf. The sauce is really, really easy. It's basically just ketchup, brown sugar. If you want to put some W sauce, which is... What's W sauce? Watch your sister. Oh, what's this? Damn, let's try it right now. Let's try it right now. Everybody, stop what you're doing. If you're driving, pull over. If you're in a club, go to the bathroom. Let's try it right now, all together. I'm going to try the W word. This is big. And I'm coming over here again, TikTok. Hold on. You ready?
You ready?
On three. One. Y'all ready? Come on. But you have to do it. If you don't do it, you're fraud. If you don't do it, just get out of here. I don't care. You ready? We're going to try to say the W word. What's the W word? The W word. One. Two. Three. Worcestershire fire. Worcestershire. I don't know why I always throw the F in there. It's because I get afraid. And I think afraid is like it just hits my brain, so I throw an F in there. I don't know. Worcestershire. 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 Oh, Worcestershire. Whoa. Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Can I get the origin, please? Worcestershire. All right. That's why people say W sauce. Shire. Worcestershire. 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 Yeah, I don't even know how they took over the world. How you sell? That's how how do you sell out off that name? I wouldn't even bought the product because I couldn't even pronounce it. How did they make money? Or maybe Worcestershire. Man, I give up. W sauce. That's why we do that. That's why we do that. Parsley flakes in the building. I put Italian herb seasoning so we don't have to do parsley flakes. Pepper. My grandma likes pepper. Did you add egg? Yep, I did two eggs. I do eggs at the end because what if you sweat out your onions and your bell peppers? The reason why people sweat it out is to bring out the flavor, and they don't truly believe when it's in the oven, they don't want it to be hard. They don't want to crunch on their onion and bell pepper. I believe if you blend your bell pepper and onion, or if you cut them in small pieces, it's in the oven for an hour. You can't tell me what the ground beef juice is not going to damn near saute or, you know, like kind of tenderize up. Or is tenderize? Did I do that? Stop playing with me. Tenderization. Tenderization. You know, guys, we got to do this together. That Gouda in her. Okay, I already read that. YouTube in the building. What's up? In with a thick. Whoa. YouTube, y'all mouths are just, y'all are fraud. Please don't spam. Fate in the building. You're not trying to monetize and I'm trying to go live. And I'm trying to go live. You're not trying to monetize and I'm trying to go live. You're not trying to monetize. What? I tried that chicken Alfredo recipe that you made and my whole family loved it. Oh my God. I know that grip is tight. He is making up new words. War's your sister. I'm so weak. Too many syllables. It's the name of a place in Europe. Okay, Carmel Drip in the building. Europe. Okay, he rolling his tenderization. Carmel Drip in the building. Carmel Drip over here talking head. Y'all gonna fire him up, TikTok? No, I'm just playing. Or her. Eminem is in the building. This is how you pronounce it. Okay, the problem is the T A. Worcestershire. Oh, Worcestershire. Oh, I like that. Worcestershire. That's easy. Worcestershire. That's what it is. That's what it is. Worcestershire. Wow. Worcestershire. Hit the gritty and I will subscribe. What's the gritty? I forgot the dance. Wow. And I'm not even being sarcastic. Hey from Texas. What's up, Texas in the bill? I'm from Texas too, DFW area. Worcestershire. 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 If I don't do the arm, I can't do it. I can. I can do anything through Christ who strengthens me. Worcestershire. All right. We're doing it. You see what happens? Do you see what happens when we believe?
Way down, 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 down. In no Texas. Woo, ain't no hold 'em. Woo, ain't no down, 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 down. Hey.
Meatloaf in the oven. If you have a thermostat or one of those temp things that you can stick in the meat, pause and check the thing, do that. You probably want to take it out about 170. Really, you want to take it out at about 150. Put your sauce on top, and then you want to do the dang thing. We have about 30 minutes left. Probably 30 minutes. I'm going to take it out, put the sauce on top. We're about to do the sauce right now. What size are you looking to have with it? I'm going to make some mashed potatoes. Let me get some of this stuff over here real quick. Let me get some of this stuff real quick. Quicksies. Oh. Can I call you love? Can I come and get sweet as you? I told you, you should have all this stuff at your house. What else do we want? And come on, baby. I'm going to tell you why I'm going to add this. I told you this company, Nutsies, they sent me some seasonings. I'm going to tell you why I'm going to add this. What else do I need? I need something else. I'm going blank. Anyway. Oh, yeah, yeah. Anytime you make meatloaf, you gotta have mashed potatoes. That's a plus. That's a definite. It's Max from yesterday. Hey, Max in the building. That's why I'm a wordsmith. Wordsmith, bro, let's go. Yes. This is how you pronounce it. Let's go. Wow, sauce. What's this here sauce? They said say this real fast. What's this here sauce? We're about to make the sauce, and I'm also wasting time. It has to be an hour in the oven, so... Y'all go eat some Doritos and brush your teeth. A lot of y'all are fraud and you need to brush your teeth. You know, nothing major. Just saying howdy. CC in the building. Thermometer. Thermostat. Thermometer. I knew it didn't sound right. Thermometer. Get your kitchen, the kitchen gadget, the thermometer. Put the thermometer in there. That's what I was thinking of. You know, my family didn't have none of that. Oh, I love watching you cook. Oh my God. Oh. Thermostat work. Thermometer, I love you guys. My bad. I was reading YouTube stuff, so now I'm going back up. My bad for reading y'all stuff late. YouTube in the building. Food, where are you? Hey, guys, I'm located in Dallas, Texas. I know you're either thinking it or you commented earlier and I missed it. If somebody asks, I'm located in Dallas, Fort Worth. I'm black. I don't know if that matters. We thought you were something else, you know, just in case you... It's Black History Month. I just felt like I had to say it. Come on, shut up. Can you go over the list of ingredients real quick? Again, 2 pounds. Okay, y'all get ready. Write this down or text it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Get your pen, paper. You ready? You ready? 2 pounds of ground beef. Come on. Whatever onions, like however amount of onions that you want, do onion and bell pepper. Come on. Onion. Okay. After that, we're going to do breadcrumbs. Probably a third cup to a cup of breadcrumbs. Put that down. Come on. Put that down. Come on. Come on. Okay, what are we going to do after that? We already went down the list. I'm asking to see if somebody remembers. Milk. Do you some milk? Come on, milk. Come on, somebody. Because remember, you need some moisture. So you got the 2 pounds of ground beef. We got the onions and bell peppers. We got the breadcrumbs. We got the milk. If you want to add you some ketchup, add you some W sauce. You want to season it up a little bit. You need seasoning. Hercules seasoning. That's a must. Then you want to toss it around. When you toss it around, after about a well, you don't want to toss around too much. Don't beat it up too much. Pause. Well, when it's time, it's time. But not right now. You know what I mean? After you like toss it around with your fingers, with your hands, and you get it all moisturized and massaged up, put your eggs in there. You're gonna do 2 eggs. For every pound of ground beef, it's 1 egg with meatloaf or I don't know what it, some people are crazy. They put it in crab cakes. Like anything that uses egg. For every pound, 1 egg. Anything that uses egg, dang near. You know what I mean? Even like I'm trying to think of something. I don't know. If you want to get crazy and do like those waffles that I did. 1 egg for 1 tablespoon of boom. You know, it's just anytime you do stuff like this. Even like sticks of butter. You do a stick of butter, 1 egg. Well, 2 eggs per stick of butter, really. Because, you know, stop. It's really two eggs. You really want to do 2 eggs per stick of butter. That's like with cakes and stuff like that. And if you want to add an extra egg, that's why they do it, just to make sure they toss another egg in there. That's just my personal opinion. Let's go ahead and make this sauce. Ground beef, onions, bell pepper, seasoning, Worcestershire sauce, ketchup, milk, eggs. Yes. And then you toss it around. After you put the eggs in there, you can put more seasoning. You toss it around. You put it in your loaf pan. You put it in the oven on 400. And you bake it for about an hour until your thermometer. Oh, my God. Or until that says 175. Or 170. Or I think for ground beef, isn't it 165 or 170 for ground beef, I think? We'll say you put in the oven. Really, you're going to put in the oven until about 150. Take that out, or about 45 minutes into it, take it out, put your sauce on top, and then put it in there until the finishing time. So now we're going to put a little ketchup in here. You can put as much ketchup as you want. I'm going to put more. We're going to do more. That's a lot of meatloaf. I did 2 pounds of ground beef. Whatever we don't need, we don't need. Now we're going to add 160. Okay, 165. So Fate says on YouTube, Fate says the tip is 165. Thank you, Fate. But you know what the cool thing is? When you think about it, we built this together. Like I asked them in the beginning, what's next? What's next? And they kept adding stuff. We'll do probably 3 to 4 tablespoons. I don't really measure stuff. So it's kind of, you know, that's one hard thing for me to do, and I hate doing it. Because I always be like, dang, because what if they follow the recipe completely? You know what I mean? And it's hard because I don't really measure stuff. I can eyeball this stuff. You know what I mean? That's how I was trained. And one thing I believe in, that another thing that people don't do, they don't taste their food. No matter what it is, even if you're scrambling eggs, taste it. If it's a wet batter that you're doing, taste it. I've seen chefs do it. So why can't we do it? Let's go ahead and mix this up a little bit. I've seen chefs do it. How come we can't do it? What's the difference? We ain't nobody. Key sweat. This is another thing. If I was selling products, I would have this. I would sell this. This is a really serious tool that a lot of people just don't want to take. Like, y'all don't take this for granted. You go get this. They say, don't take it for granted. No, take it. Take it. Go get this thing. This right here is key to a lot of good food. We need to stop sleeping on these kitchen accessories. Go find these companies, small businesses. If you're stuck, you don't know what to do, and you're in the kitchen or food business, or you're like doing that kind of work, content creation, start thinking outside the box. We don't have to do aprons and seasonings no more. We're not in that box no more. We're bigger than that. There's some people right here that don't even know. This is one of the greatest tools of all times. A rack. I told y'all, oh, this meatloaf's, God. 20 minutes into this meatloaf cooking, this thing smells like a, oh my God. Let's do a little bit of Worcestershire. I told y'all, I learned quick. Worcestershire. Let's put a little bit of Worcestershire in here. Just a little bit more because I like it. I love it. Okay, we're going to do onion powder because we can. Oh, you already put some in the meatloaf. Well, some of you don't meatloaf your meatloaf enough. And what if it don't have flavor? Then what you going to do? At least have a backup plan. The sauce. This is what the, this is why this is important. This is why a lot of people make their own, because this is your backup plan. What if you didn't season it good enough? It's not easy to season meatloaf, especially if you're not mixing it that much. That's why it's good to be using sea salts and your stuff like that. Again, this is all personal opinion. I never went to culinary school, but it sounds like I did, but I didn't. I'm just a watch TV, watch my mom, learn from disasters in the kitchen. You see how people say learn from mistakes? No, disasters. Yeah. Yeah, I was the guy. I was the guy. The only reason why I don't do pop-up and cook in front of y'all and stuff like that, because I don't believe that's my calling for Be With Cooks. I believe my calling is to change people's lives through food, but the way I'm doing it with this gastric pass, it's going to be big. Keith Lee's doing it. A lot of people are doing it. I'm always going to cook. Don't ever get it twisted. Don't ever get it twisted. It's just I'm going to change the way I'm cooking. Y'all just stay tuned. Believe in me, because I believe in you. Go to BeWithCooks.com. Donate if you have money. If you have money. Because a lot of y'all be buying McDonald's when, come on, stop. There's too many double cheeseburgers in 1 week. So take some of that double cheeseburger, $3 now. They just stiff. Take that $3 plus change, which is almost damn near $5 just to get a water and a double cheeseburger. Just send that to Be With Cooks just this week. That's it. I got 1 million followers. If 1 million followers send me $1, it's $1 million. We can start changing the world. BeWithCooks.com. Say it slower. BeWithCooks.com. This right here is from Nuxie's Seasonings. Nuxie's Seasonings. This is called Chicken Dust. I just released a video on them. I do Gasser Pass where I give brands exposure. I try to get them sales or whatever. Right now, I mean, I'm just starting it, so it got to pick up, but it's going to pick up. But she sent this seasoning. I did say it was mid. Mid don't mean it's bad. It's still good. It's just, what's the point of giving somebody a 7.5, a 6.3, and all that stuff? What's the point when it's just mid? That's what mid is. 5.3. Oh, I'll give this a 6.7. That's mid. Like, what are we doing? It's good or not? Like, you know? So that's what I do Gasser Pass for. Her chicken dust is garlic powder. Oh, that's why I didn't want to do this. I'm tripping. But I'm going to still put some in there. A lot of people put rosemary or dry, Italian herb seasoning. A lot of people put that in their meatloaf. This has Italian herb seasoning, and it's called chicken dust. So it has your garlic powder, your onion powder, your salts, all that, and it's vegan. I should have used her stuff for my whole thing. That's what I should have did. I'm going to just put a little bit in there because it has that, you know, it has that Italian herb seasoning. And we're using it anyway on our stuff. And this right here, as simple as it is, you can add barbecue sauce to this. You can add a citrus. A lot of people do like a lemon juice or just to bring out the flavors. That's it. Just put a little bit of orange zest or a little bit of fresh squeezed orange juice. Something like that if you want to. I'm not going to do that. Remember, you could... Stop playing with me. Yeah, stop playing. Yeah, don't play. Step back. Don't play with me. Yeah, step back. Step back, I'm on the way. What my boy say? Police! yeah, go get him. Hey, that's my boy. Police! Oh, my... Oh! That's my boy. Throw you a little vinegar in there. I'm going to do a little apple cider vinegar. TikTok, I'm getting to your comments. I'm going to do a little bit of apple cider vinegar. And again, all this... Anytime you're adding a sweet, anytime you're adding a vinegar or a bitter or a citrus, it's just to alley-oop each other. It's to bring out each other. You know what I mean? I'm going to bring my best self so I can get your best self. That's what you're doing with those flavors. Okay? So even if I do a vinegar, I did an apple cider vinegar and I did a Worcestershire. Oh my God. I just said it so quick. I'm going to backdoor with a little bit. Damn, what's it, brown sugar hair? What is this? Oh, okay, that was a liquid. Put a little bit more brown sugar in there. That's gonna take it to the top. Oh, the apple cider vinegar is it. That's going to give it this. You know what I mean? You know, like, you could do the lemon or the orange, or you could do the apple cider vinegar. You know what I mean? I've been cooking since elementary school. Come on, Carmel Drip. Drop your donation link, dear. It's BeWithCooks.com. I'm sorry that I'm not big on YouTube, but I don't know how to do that on YouTube yet, and I don't want to mess up anything. But it is bwoodcooks.com. Again, one of the major things I'm trying to do is take Gas or Pass on the road to use my platform and to invest in some of these companies that don't have resources, like CC Sweets, one of the greatest cookies I ever had in my life. Why not try to get that to you guys at your front doorstep? Y'all buy Mrs. Fields and Oreos and all that anyway. What's the difference? But you don't know she exists. I'm just giving an example. I don't know what she's doing now, but I'm just giving an example. Like, what if I flew to her or talked to her behind the scenes, set up some stuff, get the content, make it look like TV. I'm a network. Be What Cooks. It's my job to create content. But it's just the way I want to do it is involve you guys. Like, y'all are actors. I can't do it with everybody. I can't help everybody. It's not one of those things. It's just y'all have the products. Why come out with a seasoning when y'all got the seasoning? You know, this is how I look. Everybody's not like that, though. It's not for everybody. This is just what I want to do. So if you believe in me and you believe in the situation, if you can, even if you believe in me and you can't donate, sign up on the email list, because that's how you get the free gifts. Y'all just see me release a video. I'm going to give you free stuff. Let's do right now. Right now. Give me how many I got right now. I'm going to do it right in front of you. Right now. These are those bacon mats that I use. I could have used this on the meatloaf. These are the bacon mats I use in my videos for cookies, cinnamon rolls, and all that. If you sign up on the email list, you get these for free. These value at 30, 40 bucks in the store. Some of y'all don't even know these exist. And the ones that exist suck. This brand hadn't even came out with these. They said they're not going to come out with them. And I have a whole bunch of these. So if you sign up on the email list, I'll give it to you for free. But the donations help me get shipping supplies, help me ship it through UPS and all this different stuff. It helps me get a team so I can send emails out to these businesses, get products because they want exposure. So if I send 100 emails out to these businesses that I don't have time because I have a job, I got to create content, I got to do a whole bunch of other stuff. But if I hire like an assistant, just an example, you send out these emails to these businesses, get y'all product just off of little donations. 1 million followers donate $1. That's $1 million. I can start hiring people, start traveling, start doing some stuff, and we can really impact the world. So when y'all hear me say it, I have the plan on paper. I have the vision. I just want the right team. It takes the right team. I know. Oh, okay. Anyway, go to bwoodcooks.com. Sorry for screaming. Oh my God, turn your phone down. Go to bwoodcooks.com, donate, and then Imperial did this. Imperial believed in me when I had no followers, man. When I had like 500 followers, they sent me this. Like, this is crazy. They not sent me this, but they believed in me. They saw me then. Hidden Valley Ranch, they saw me then. Kroger's right now hit me up in the email. They see me. Not the bad word, but I could PIMP them to get money to give to you guys because they want exposure. I'm the funnel to get, just believe in me. Go to bwoodcooks.com. If you don't have, it's not about the money. At least do your part by watching my videos because I get paid from content. Sorry for spitting. Wipe your phone off. And then if you have the bread, so we can support everybody in the community, donate. That's what the donate's for. Because I do want to say, look, there's some people right now. There's this lady. She said, hey, what about the homeless? What about the less fortunate? The less fortunate, what they going to do with this? They don't have an oven. What they going to do with this? So I said my followers. So because I don't know who's less fortunate or not. So if you're on the email list or you're a top donor, I'm sending it. That's all I can. I can control what I can control. You see what I'm saying? I can control that. Hey, if you follow me, I'll just pick random people. I'll go live, pick the random people, we'll do different awards. I'll give out $10,000 here, $1,000 here. Like, but that's what I want to do. Everybody don't want to do it like that, though. Don't worry about me generating money. I'm going to get the money. Don't worry about me. I'm going to make my money. Don't worry about me. Yeah, y'all don't worry about me. I'm going to make my money. I just need the donations to really get it going and started. Or I could come out with a cookbook or a spatula and all this stuff to get the money. Like, regardless, I'm going to get the money. So, hey, it's just how we going to get it. I got 1 million followers. You send me $1. That's $1 million. And I can start impacting the world. That's it. One business at a time. That's it. And when I told you, when I get my studio, I told you I'm a network. So this is just one of the ideas. So when I get my studio, I got to obviously hire a receptionist or whoever to work there or whatever I do, or somebody to, you know, do the stuff, whatever. I told y'all I want to do one of the things I want to do. I have literally 20 ideas of what I'm going to do for content. Literally. That's seasons of stuff. But one of the things I want to do is a dating show. You know, it's hard to find love. But I wanted to cook and I wanted to entertain y'all, cook. And like each, I want to get 10 couples. That's 10 episodes. 10 females, 10 guys, or however, whatever. You know, these days you got to do whatever. So it don't matter how you do it. But I want to get 10 and 10, right? 10 episodes. I cook, entertain, and then we just do almost like a dating show and see if they find love and all that crap. That's just one idea. Remember, it's my job to create content. That's just one idea out of a million ideas. A cooking show. I flop like my followers in to come see my studio, sit behind the scenes. They get to be part of the show, like a real network. But I need a studio. I'm not talking about big time studio. I'm talking about like a little space, $2,000 a month. That's it. Like, I'm not trying to go big. I'm just $1,500 a month. I'm cheap. That's why I say, what y'all donate to me? I'm cheap. Well, I might get an apartment, a bigger apartment somewhere. Just do that for right now. I have vision. I literally have 20 ideas, but I have three that's big. I can't let you know the three. Gasser Pass is one of the big ones, but it's big. It's just believe. Go to BeWithCooks.com. We did the sauce, meatloaf in the oven. Now we're gonna start our potatoes. Y'all just gotta believe. It's not for everybody. You know what I mean? This is just what I used to have a car dealership where I sold cars buy here, pay here. And buy here, pay here is when you give people that have bad, like they used to have good credit, now they have bad credit, and they need a second chance, they need another car. Be What Cooks was already Be What Cooks then. I just never had the name. It was never Be What Cooks. I had Wood Auto Group. I was doing the same thing then, trying to help people. That's it. I was doing it then. Yeah. This ain't nothing new. It's just now you know Be What Cooks. That's it. This ain't nothing new. I've been cooking these recipes. I just didn't know these recipes would be the funnel to change the world. That's it. I've been cooking recipes. I've been doing this. If you go look at my car dealership page, I got old recipes on my car dealership page from like 3-4 years ago. I've been doing this. I never knew that Be What Cooks would lead me to change the world. As corny as that crap sounds. I know it sounds corny, but it's the truth. It's the truth. I used to have a media page. I had a media page called Original Be What Cooks. I'm going to read your comments in a little bit. I had a media page called Original Be What or Original Be What. I had 90,000 followers. I was talking the same thing without Be What Cooks. It's the same vision. I ain't changed. I got two people as my witness. I got my mom on TikTok. She my witness. That's why she'll forever be my mom. Her name is Danny D. She my witness and God my witness. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? Y'all just believe in me. That's it. I can't help everybody. This is not a thing saying I'm going to help everybody. But you sign up on the email list. I'm going to pick some random people today. I'm going to send you an email. So how it works is the email list is like this. So how I'm going to talk to y'all is going to be through text and email. Whoever does it, all I'm asking you to do is sign up. So what I know, when you sign up, that means I know that you're willing to do the work. So because you're going to do that for me and you're going to watch my videos and you're going to donate for me so I can monetize and I can live a good life too. And so we can really change the world and really get some stuff done. Because you're doing that, I'm going to make sure you're good. I have over 1 million followers. I can't do that. Just do the math. If I get any kind of product over 1 million followers, I don't have that amount of money. But if I affect this one person that already has a business, I can affect everybody. Because remember this, people get an emotional connection with food. These people have brands and products and food and kitchen accessories. If I get them to your doorstep, we got you an emotional connection. And we change that person to then change the next person. Then it's a cause and effect. It's like an ecosystem. So that's why I said I got to take gas or pass on the road, because some of these people got better. That stuff that we buy in the stores, I got some gas or pass products that's killing that stuff. But you don't know they exist, but you're about to. that's all Gasser Pass is. You don't know they exist now, but you're about to. You don't have to do no all this. Oh, get on Shark Tank. You got to do all these different tryout. We don't have that time. We're just about to change the world. We're about to do it now. We're not about to set up. Oh, let's do 6 months worth of. No, we're doing it now. These days, all you need is a phone. Wallow said, if you have an iPhone, you got $5 million in your hand. That's it. Ain't nothing else to talk about. You got an iPhone, you got $5 million in your hand. If you got a Google phone, you got $5 million in your hand. What you doing? What you doing? What you doing? Only reason why y'all ain't posting is because you either don't believe in yourself, you're not confident, you're insecure, you just really ain't got no plan, or you just don't know how to do it. It's just the mindset. I didn't know how to do none of this either. I'm just about to go around the world and just change the mindset. Anybody can do what I'm doing. But there's little tricks I know, though. That's it. Anybody can do what I do. I'm not here to change your whole business. I'm here to change your mindset. The reason why you're not selling products and the reason why you don't have communities is your mindset. That's it. Because you can do what I'm doing. I'm no different than nobody here. That's it. But the only difference is when I had 100 views on my videos, I kept going. It was a mindset. That's it. When I had my business with Wood Auto Group and I had to shut it down, I immediately moved to Be What Cooks. It was a mindset. That's it. I'm just selling the mindset to you. That's it. You could do anything I'm doing. I had a failed business. Come on. You can do anything I'm doing. You can do it. Like, this is easy work. The reason why you don't post, because you have, there's something there. You're scared about not getting the views and all that. It's not about that. You're not supposed to get the views. That's what the business, you started a business, oh, you're just going to get the CEO job? No, you start from the bottom. Like, come on, this ain't rocket science. This ain't rocket science. We just about to change the mindset. That's it. I ain't got no business degree. I don't have to have no business degree. I know social media, though. I don't have to have no business degree now. I know social media. What's up? I don't need no business degree right now. I don't need one. I'm a black man in America that just had a business. I had a business. I sold cars. I have my own car dealership. I know what I'm doing. I ain't that stupid. You know what I mean? Like I said, I'm just a puzzle piece. I'm not, what if your business makes money? How can I benefit you? Well, what if my audience helps you? What if you don't have money? Well, what, like Keith Lee. Keith Lee gives these companies $2,500, $4,000. That gives you a breath of fresh air for at least a week. I can do the same thing and I can sell you some product. I got the plan. Remember, it's my job to create the content. That's the difference. Everybody has the idea, but can you put it on camera? I can. That's why you trust me. Same thing with HBO Max. It's the same concept. They invest in people that can give you good product, like Euphoria's and stuff like that. It's the same concept. It's my job to be the network. That's it. And remember, you guys cooks, there's some people that cook better than me. There's some people that got product that I don't have. So I'm just going to use you, just like those networks would. That's it. So go to bewithcooks.com, at least sign up on the email list. That's how I'm going to talk to you. But when I do text messages, the text messages is because some people don't know how to do the email and some people don't understand the internet. So I want to have it set up where you can text bewoodcooks at 33333 and then it's just immediate link. Like not nothing, it's just you can text sign up at 33333 and it immediately puts you on the sign up list. Like I because some people don't understand the internet, so I want to make everything easy as possible. That's why I want to do the SMS. So eventually you'll see me get SMS and I'll introduce that to y'all. I know I need another knife, but we're not going to do any. Oh, y'all never see me cut. Oh, God. I should have did it back there, man. Ah! Hey, y'all say anything, you're out of here. I'm booting you. Hey, Ma, get your fingers ready. Let me go to TikTok for a little bit. I know I've been rambling. I'm just really passionate about it. Guys, I'm sorry for not giving you attention. I'm really good at actually giving you attention, believe it or not. But there's a lot of replayers that I'm worried about. You know what I mean? So, and there's a lot of cooks. I follow a lot of cooks before I went live. They don't even talk to y'all's comments. So I know that y'all want the comments. I know you want the attention. But all this attention, keep the same energy. Oh, let me put the knife down. I'm trying to monetize. Keep the same energy. Because when I'm on the road and I'm pulling up on y'all, I don't want no nervousness then. When I'm doing these pop-ups and I'm saying, pull out the camera, your wigs and all that better be ready. Like, I'm just letting you know, I don't play games. Oh, we didn't know. You think I'm playing with donation money? Come on. Like, come on, man. Come on, man. I just cut some red potatoes. Anytime you're making mashed potatoes for me, I think red's the best. Come on. You want to cut them evenly. You know what I'm saying, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Ooh, we'll get the good pop, because I ain't trying to hear your mouth. TikTok. I'm coming, TikTok, I'm coming. I promise you. No lemon, baby, yeah. I'm getting to your comments. Hold on, let me wash this out real quick. I'm really, really cringe about that. I believe every pot that I use, I have to wash out or I can't use. I'm scared, like a bug touched it or something. And I believe bugs leave residue. So, to the residue. So, again, I appreciate y'all. I appreciate the people that are in here, and I'm not giving you attention. I know that y'all want attention. I want attention, too. That's why I go live, right? But, no, I do appreciate you guys. I appreciate the likes. I appreciate the new follows. I appreciate the replayers on YouTube. I really do appreciate y'all, man. I really do. You know, when I did that video of that guy that I had, it was real. It was real. I did that video because it's real. That was my first like encounter with a follower from social media. And it was just so crazy how it was like right down the street from me. So here, let me get another towel. Let me redo this. So I just thought that was pretty cool. That was my first, like, I mean, I've seen followers before, and they're like, oh, you whatever. I've met followers before, so let me not say that. But that was my first time doing something like, you know what I mean? Like, that was, like, part of the mission. So I just thought that was pretty cool. Danny D, she got her pack. You sign up on bwoodcooks.com, you get free stuff. I showed you those bacon mats that I have. This lady, she sent me a whole bunch of these. So little stuff like this, like, why? Like, if I use, like, maybe two or three, and maybe, example, she sent me 10 of these, I can ship out 7. Because what happens is I ship it out. What's the number one way to market for all the marketers? Or what's the number one way of marketing? What do they say? Other than referrals. But what do they say? Word of mouth. Like, come on. Like, this is minor stuff. So if I ship it to you, it's word of mouth. Like, if it's something that you like, you're going to fiend for it. I'm just telling businesses, give me enough because I have real audience. I know who to pick out. I know what to do. You know what I mean? I know how to do it. I know how to get stuff done. I have it all on paper. It's a real plan and it's going to work. But little stuff like that. I love this thing. She actually did a really good job. She just doesn't have a website. She can't sell it. So I didn't make a video for it. But she really did a good job. I like this. Isn't this cool? You can see this at least at Dollar Tree. I'm not knocking. I'm just saying, wouldn't this be a good Dollar Tree thing? Like, they buy all this little crap at Dollar Tree. Buy this for... and sell this at $7.99, $8.99. Come on. This is easy. You can put this in Dollar Tree. Packaging costs tapes. Packaging. We ain't even got to put a packaging. You put a little hook thing on there. Let it hook off. Put the little tag on there from Dollar Tree or Family Dollar. We'll sell the deal to Family Dollar. So put the little tag on Family Dollar like it's theirs. We'll sell the design to them and they can claim it. And they can sell this for $8.99, $10.99. But I can connect the dots because I got the follower. She don't know what she's doing. She even hit me up in an email. She don't know what she's doing. But I do. You see what I'm saying? That's why I got to take gas or pass on the road. I've done the work, man. I didn't do the work to just keep giving y'all free recipes. It's bigger than that. It's bigger than just free recipe. I'm going to keep always giving y'all free recipes. That's why I want the studio. And that's why I want to pull up on y'all because I can use y'all as recipes. Come on. So let's do 6 cups of water. A lot of people do chicken broth. A lot of people do chicken broth. But we ain't doing that. A lot of people do chicken broth. All the big back people do chicken broth. All my big back community, BBC. Whoa. All my big back community, they use chicken broth when they do mashed potatoes. We not. Pause. Eminem in the building. You still here? What's up, Eminem? My boy. He's still locked in. You a day one? What's up? Meatloaf and potato is on the menu tonight. Meatloaf and potatoes, guys. Again, if you don't see the title, it is meatloaf and potatoes. Oh, we can take our meatloaf out and put the sauce on top. Ooh, woo! She's a brick. Fan of auto house. She's mighty, mighty. Oh, she's a brick. A chicka bow, chicka bow, chicka bow, wow. All right, let me pull this out real quick. Damn. Let me pull this out real quick. Let me pull it, just so y'all can see it, and then I'm gonna take it out a little bit. And then while I'm gonna put the potatoes in here, and then I'm gonna do the sauce. I just want to see, you know, this is when we do the sauce. This is about 45 minutes in there. Oh, you can't see it. This is why I say, hey, you can drain the juices or keep it in there and then take the juices out at the end. It's up to you. I keep the juices and then I drain it. I don't know if you can see that. Ain't no sunshine when she calls. Boom, boom, boom. Hit on him, hang on. That's one of them. Ain't no sunshine when she calls. That's that type of song when you see Meatloaf. So, let's do that. This is when you do the sauce. Again, with the grease, just keep the grease in there. And then when you take the meatloaf out, go ahead and, you can just keep the, you could just keep the grease in there. You could just pull the ground beef out. You know what I mean? That's why people let it sit another like 10, 15 minutes after they take it out the oven. So it could just sit and be that firm. I should have packed it a little bit more, but I would rather not pack it than pack it, if that makes sense. Oh, yeah. Anytime she goes away. Bam, bam, bam. Anytime she goes away. Woo! Killer. I know. Ain't on that M. Shit, you can never put enough sauce on there, baby.
Yeah, baby. And I say hello.
Okay. Ooh, this hot boy.
I'm a hot boy.
Meatloaf. We're going to put it back in the oven for another 15 to 20 minutes. Meatloaf. Hello there, Betty. Hello, Bucko. Hello, Choppy. We're going to put it back in the oven for another 15 to 20 minutes. We're making a meatloaf. Also, if you missed the recipe, you can go on YouTube because I will post this on YouTube. And you can replay it on YouTube. Isn't that great? Because I've said the recipe like a million times on YouTube. Okay. Mashed potatoes. We're going to teach you the secrets to the best mashed potatoes of your life. Meatloaf in the oven for another 15 to 20 minutes. You're going to bake it on 400 for about an hour to an hour and 10 minutes. Some of your oven don't oven. It just uff. So you might have to do 415, 425. Maybe 450. Because your oven ain't ovening. That's oven. B. Wood got the recipe. Okay, Fate in the building. Jimson also makes awesome gravy. 100%. Oh, look at you, Fate. Fate going crazy with the ideas. Yeah, you use that. Get some onion. It's the same way you make gravy. I don't see why. I used to see the fear in gravy. Now I don't see it. All you're using, like she said, use the drippings or the grease or the oil, whatever you want to call it. You could put butter in a skillet, but you don't even have to. Just do some onion, put some flour in there, about 3 to 4. Always remember, you ain't making it for a big crowd. Just do 3 to 4 tablespoons of flour. Maybe 5. That's it. You're just trying to put some heat to it to get it slushy. Then you're going to add the grease to it. And then if you need to make it thinner, you're just going to add some water or what? Chicken broth. That's it. This stuff ain't hard, man. Let's see. We're going back on the comments. I'm sorry again, TikTok. We're going up. Some of these comments. We're waiting on our water to boil for the mashed potatoes. I got some red potatoes that I cut sitting on the side. What we making? Okay, mashed potatoes. Just mashed potatoes. I think I'm gonna do frozen bag of mixed vegetables or whatever I have in a freezer. We'll put that in a microwave, or you can do it in a skillet. You can pan fry it. Like, people sleep on them frozen vegetables, be gas, and it's quick. You'll definitely get to where you want. Facts. Get the money. G, we all love you and believe in you. Dang, Eminem. Eminem really been holding it down for me. I ain't gonna lie. Like, Eminem, like, and it's a dude. You know, a lot of dudes don't really be staying in here. You know, whatever. But first of all the dudes crazy. I got all the female be over here. Y'all really need to be spitting the game. Really. Unless you weak. Let me find out. I would definitely come to a live show. See? Oh, I told y'all, one of my things for content. So my dad's opening up a restaurant. It's going to be a hot wing place. I think he said now he's going to do the food truck. I said the food truck from the jump, but I don't know yet. But he's going to open up a hot wing place, and he's going to do hot wings and chicken sandwiches, right? Because they don't have it in this town. They only have, like, barbecue and have all these different things. So what I was going to do is, it's easy to say that your food's good. But if I taste test it and I invite two or three of my followers, my dad's cool as hell. My dad don't cuss. He don't drink. He don't do none of that. He's just a good guy. If I invite two or three of my followers from random places and we go down there, go visit my dad. He has a little car dealership out there that he runs. So we'll rent a car from him. We'll go check out the restaurant or the food truck. We'll eat the food, taste test it, and I'll get it on video and we release the video. Remember, I get paid from content too. So, but it would be cool to interact with two or three of my followers. It don't matter if you're male, female, whatever. And I'm going to pick three random people, or maybe two. Three is a lot. Two is cool, like, for what we're doing. I'm talking about money-wise, because we don't have a lot of money in the donation bucket right now. And he might open up the restaurant within the next 30 days to 60 days. So I'm probably about to go out there next month, sometime the second week of March, or third week of March. I'm going to drive. It's a five-hour drive from where I am, or I can fly out there and be there in 45 minutes. So I might fly out there, which is my money, not donation. All the money that I use for us, it will be... that's the money that I use from donations for us. It's not like for my personal stuff. I'm using my money. I get money from content. So I don't need to use donation money for my personal life. Now, the money that I make from impacting businesses and using affiliation codes and sponsor, like whatever I can use from sponsorship money and all that, that's my money because I put in the work to do that. But the initial money startup is the investment is investing in the Be What Cooks community. So that's all for that. My personal money I get from content. Like I make money from content. I don't make a lot. I make enough. $3,000 to $4,000 a month is decent, plus my regular job that I work at. So I'm fine right now, but I have a plan. Remember, if I'm investing in these companies, I'll have affiliate codes, I'll have all type of stuff. When it gets to that point, some gas or pass companies, I'm not gonna invest in them. We'll just go taste the food, do the video there, and go about our business. You know what I mean? Like, hey, if the food ain't good, it ain't good. I can't tell my people, hey, this is what we doing. Hey, y'all, we found this company, the food okay, we about to invest in them. I can't tell y'all that. You know what I mean? It's almost like we're a publicly traded company. Like, y'all are putting up donation. I'm about to show y'all, like, hey, this is what we spending money on. This is what we doing. Like, the idea is going to be cool. Y'all just got to, just believe in me. Just believe. That's why I say it takes a team, because this one's big. Like, we're going to be like a publicly traded company. Like, y'all going to be, like, sending money. You're going to see where your money's going. You're going to see how I impact people. Then you get free stuff in return. Just like dividends. You invest in stocks, you get dividends. Or you get coupons from the company. You get to be on the board of the company. Big donors, they get big spots on Be What Cooks. It's that simple. Businesses, anybody that own a business, send me more products than just what for samples. I want to send them to my followers because if they taste your product and it's really good, they'll order more. That's a customer. Just like a restaurant. You go to a restaurant the first time, the food is good. We're waiting on the pot to boil, so I'm just rambling. If the food is good at a restaurant, for the first time, and you go there for the first time, you'll probably go back. If it's trash, then come on. So we only got one shot. So that's why y'all see me getting stiff on gas or pass, because I can't play with y'all. I can't. Like the lady, I did one of the company. I'm not going to call them out, but one of the companies, I said gas. And I thought it was gas. Everybody has different opinions. But I knew it wasn't that gas. I knew it wasn't that gas. But I was iffy on it. But instead of me just doing mid, I did gas. And the reason why I say I'm glad she hit me up and said that, because it made me tighten up on gas or pass. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have tightened up. But because she said that, she was like, hey, I ordered it and it wasn't that good. It was okay. She had the same feeling I had. She literally had the same feeling I had in my comment. I said, okay, bet. That's my sign to tighten up. Because you know you want to be nice to everybody. But it's not about that. People are ordering this product. Nobody want trash. We don't care about nice. We want good product. That's why we spend the money on. We don't spend money on them basic. That's okay. We can just do whatever. We can make these at the crib. Like, but we spending money for the experience, the emotion, the value, and that thing. You know what I mean? Come on. So gas or pass is on the road. There's some people that are scared to do video. That's cool. If I'm investing in a company, I'll give them 10 videos, 20 videos already made of me, and they can always use that for advertising and keep doing it. That's what businesses do. They buy content. That's part of my gas or pass. I'm giving y'all a game right now for me. I have it all planned. I have it all on paper. I'm just waiting on the team. I need a certain amount of money to start working on the team. Because I already have everything on paper. I have all my notes. Bro, don't do this. Like, where my phone at? Come on, man. This ain't even. Hey, I do this. Ain't. What did Jay-Z say? I do this in my sleep. I told you. Like, we do this, man. I love this. this is my baby. B-Wood Cooks is my baby. Like, when people say, this lady, she said that I took her recipes, right? These are my little notes for my, like, of recipes that I do. These are my ideas. Like, y'all gotta stop doing this. Don't do me. Like, these are ideas. You know what I mean? Like, this is, I can't go down because I think I have some, like, passwords on here. I don't know. But yeah, it goes down. Like, this is just for like ideas of just little foods. This is my little donor list of all the people that I have that I'm sending gifts to. This is my little donor list. Like, come on, man. Like, look, I have a master class that I'm working on right here. like, come on. Like, my little master class. I got my opening, like, my pitch, how I'm going to talk to people when I do the gastro pass, like, what I'm going to say and stuff like that. I have all that written. Like, for real, I'm not playing with this. Then, remember, I'm on two other phones, YouTube and TikTok. I have notes in those phones. Like, this is real. I didn't show y'all everything because, you know, people want to fraud. But this is real, bro. I'm not playing with this. This is my baby. This is all I got. This is my legacy to my daughter. This is my legacy for the world, bro, because they can replay these videos. This is my legacy. This is all I got. I'm all in. That's it. Hey, I'm all in with B-Wood Cooks, baby. The mission is to change the world through recipes, baby. That's it. So, yeah, family of four got me rambling when she said I would definitely come to a live show. That turns me up. Why do y'all think I come up with stuff like, oh, my God, and like PCTs? Because I can see the audience screaming it. I can see me having a studio inviting 10 people to see the behind the scenes, get to meet me, get to eat my food, get to really experience like the B-Wood Cooks experience, and everything's free. Why pay money? When I make money off content, y'all can just donate a dollar. Like, why are we, what are we doing? A dollar gives me $1 million from 1 million followers and we can start really moving. What's the point of y'all buying products for $40? That's stupid. There's no point. Just invest a dollar and we can really get free stuff. It's that simple. Because the bigger I get, more companies are going to want to donate money and all that. I have the plan. Again, I'm not doing something that's out of the... There's so many people that's doing what I'm doing. It's just... I know this sounds cocky, but I'm ADHD and they got to be me. Everybody's separate. Like, Steve Harvey said it best. Like, I can help whoever I want to help because we're all different. You can't take away from me because what's for me is what's for me. So I don't care about helping people and giving people my platform. And that's what Gastro Pass is. What can you take from me? There ain't nothing you can take from me. like whatever is meant for me is meant for me. Come on, man. That's why I don't care about helping people. We here. Frozen vegetables really do in a pinch. Yeah, you already know what it is. The drippings also make an awesome gravy. You already know what it is, awesome gravy. Okay, our water is boiling. So we're going to add our potatoes. All the replayers, if you're tired of the rambling, make sure you fast forward. Everybody that's in here, I appreciate you. I appreciate all the people that commented and I didn't pay attention to you. Eminem's been holding it down for me. Danny D, I was holding it down. Vanita, she's actually been holding it down in messages, telling people what's up with the meatloaf. Fate been holding it down over here on YouTube. Caramel Drip been holding it down with the jokes and on YouTube. All the replayers, y'all holding it down if you made it this long because this is a 98-minute video. The longer you watch my videos on YouTube, I actually get paid from that, which also helps us. Like, don't ever get it twisted like I'm not trying to make money. I'm not going to fraud you. Don't ever get it twisted. But the way my dad told me something when I was a little kid, I love to count my dad. He told me something when I was a little kid. The number one way to make money is investing in people. That's it. What do you think a bank is? Same concept. What do you think anything is? And number one way to make money is investing. He told me that when I was 11 years old. I was in Dallas at a meeting. He had a meeting at Live Oak Restaurant. Only reason why I remember this is because the pork chops sucked and I ordered fried pork chops. I had fried pork chops, cabbage, and I don't know the other side. But I always remember this meeting because he had a big $1 million meeting for this real estate stuff. And I accidentally flicked water on the guy he was having a meeting with. So I'll never forget that day because of that one incident. He got pissed. My dad don't get mad at nothing. But he was like, Brian, what? And he looked at me. I was like, whoa. I will never forget that day. That's why when my memory's trained to remember from patterns. Like, what these recipes, when people say you took them, yo, yeah. I saw my mom do this for literally 18 years. I saw my mom cook the same food and my grandma cook the same food and my aunt. Stop. I could do this. I could mouth these recipes off for days. Stop playing with me, boy. Stop playing with me. Don't play with me like that. I could do this for days, boy. Don't do that. My brother. I don't even talk about my brother. My brother's a pastor now, a preacher. He don't even know if he watches this. I love you, bro. he don't even know that when I'm like trying to unfold why is God trying to use me with be with cooks and where this cooking come from. I used to make music. I learned how to make music from my brother. My brother, when I used to stay with my brother in the summertime, he used to go to culinary school. You never know something unless you keep doing the work. I didn't manifest this. I just kept doing the work. I kept trying to follow the journey. But now since I'm trying to unfold the journey, I'm trying to figure out where did this passion come from? What is this? My brother, me loving music is because of my mom and my brother. When my brother went to culinary school, that baked beans recipe, he don't even realize that I got that from him. Him and his homeboy were having a match of who's the best cook. And one day their competition was baked beans. So the dude was like, I'm from Mississippi. I make the best baked beans. I remember stuff like this because it'd be enjoyable moments. So I'll never forget them. I was 13 years old, probably 12, 13 years old, 14. The year that Headsprung came out with LL Cool J, that's how old I was. The year that Headsprung came out. So, you and that booty. The year that all that stuff came out. When I'm in a second, definite booty. Whatever year that was, that's the age I was. And I was born in 89. But I will never forget the baked beans because I was there when he was cooking them. I'll never forget. So that's just little things like that, how my brain is just, I'm ADHD. This is just how my brain is paired up. Dude, I think it's a gift. People complain about ADHD. I think it's a gift. God gave me a gift. Like, do you see what Kanye West is doing? I don't trust. Everything Kanye West does is not, like, valid for me. But it makes sense. Like, he's just trying to tell you, hey, I'm an autistic guy. I have bipolar. Like, it's just crazy to know that you would think that autism and bipolarness is not a power, but he's showing you it is. Because with those things that he turned it to not have fear. Like, he can go do stadiums and he can go do these things because he has those things. I have ADHD, so there's some things that y'all are scared to do or some things that you don't have energy for that I just naturally have. I believe it's a power. That's it. It's a power, baby. What state you? I'm in Texas. Your website only lets you donate a minimum of $5. Yeah. I just learned that the other day. I thought it was a dollar. So let me stop saying that. So $5. So we got 1 million followers and $5. I swear I thought it was a dollar. And I remember that I did. It is $5. I'm glad you said that. All right, it is $5. Minimum is $5. So if you ain't got $5, my bad. It is $5. You're 100% right. It is $5. I think I already hit up WordPress, but I don't know if they let you do anything below $5, which is stupid. PayPal and Stride and these companies run all the stuff, and I think those are the only tabs they have, but you are right 100%. I knew you had ADHD a little. Oh, yeah, 100% on ADHD. Yeah, Kanye's bipolar. He's been talking about it his whole career. I mean, just going on a little Kanye. So I like Kanye as one of my favorite rappers and Jay-Z. Kanye's been telling y'all forever that he has autism and that he's bipolar and that he has issues. And then on top of that, his mother passed away. What are we talking about? There's nothing to talk about. Like, my mom passed away, I wouldn't even know what to do. Like, I wouldn't even know how to survive. And, like, I know what's going to happen one day. I just wouldn't know how to do anything. I'm just being honest. It's a lot of pressure. And then, like he said recently, he said in the TMZ or in one of those things, like, I was just telling them that I'm bipolar and I have a little autism. But they or I was telling them that I had autism and they wanted to say that I had bipolarness and they started giving me pills and I started gaining weight. That's what Kanye West said. And I one thing about me is if you say something, I'm gonna just believe what you say until you show me something different. He ain't showed me nothing different. Everything he said he's done, he's gonna do. He's done it. A lot of people say he went crazy. Do you realize how are you gonna get out of your record deals? If you don't hire lawyers and try to get all these people to get you out your record deals and all these Adidas deals, how are you gonna do it? Isn't it so crazy he got out these deals just by talking crap? Hey, I don't like this people, and then they got him out his deal. Rather than spending millions to get a lawyer to get you out of a deal, all he had to do was talk crap for a day. Why do y'all think that picture with that Adidas person was so big? The same person he was talking about, he took a picture with him. It's to show you that all he was trying to do was get out the deal to be independent. Like, guys, why do you think he gave Pitcher T his masters? Guys, because he's on that move of independency. That's why I don't. Kroger's hit me up in the email, and I haven't done the Kroger's. They want to pay me money to do a ad. I'm not doing it because of what they're asking me to do. I'm the creator. You just give me the money and let me create. You don't tell me what to do. Just give me little separate parameters. You don't tell me what to do. I 2 weeks I can't post this. No, that's not how it works because I don't need you. I have a community. I have almost $3,000 in donations now. I don't need what the little money that you're gonna give me. And I have to be your slave. Come on, stop. I'm not building a community to be a slave. I'm building a community to win. Like, we're not building a community to work for nobody. We build a community to be free. Like, what you talk about? We ain't no, we ain't. So again, a lot of people want to get on Ye. I ain't getting on Ye. I'm not getting on Ye. I'm sorry. I get it. When he's taking, now, remember, he has autism. If you watch the Genius documentary, there's something is wrong with Kanye West. We're not saying there's not. But knowing that that is real, it's not justifying his actions. I just understand what's going on. When you're one of the biggest icons in the world and nobody's listening to you, how do you get them to listen? Monique just did the same thing. Does it make it right? No. His execution is 100% off. But don't, the dude is, it's he's different. That's all I'm going to say. The boy's an icon. Say what you want to say. So he lost billions purpose, you saying? No, he lost, no. The dude only had two, we'll just say 3 billion. He was worth 3 billion and he went to 400 million. He didn't have $3 billion in the bank. He had $3 billion worth of assets. I'll give you a perfect example. My job that I work right now is $2,000 a month. He pays me $2,000 a month plus commission. Plus I make money from social media, so I'm fine. I could easily go work a job making $5,000 to $7,000, maybe $10,000 a month. I used to sell cars. I could easily sell cars, make $10,000 to $15,000 a month. But at what expense? That's the problem. What is time is everything, right? Time is valuable. Time is worth more than money, right? I got to do all these designs, fly and do all this work. At what expense to have, just to say I have $3 billion? $3 billion just as equal as $400 million. You might not can go buy a football team, but it's still the same, almost the same money. So to say that I'm independent and I don't have to rely on nobody, I just lose a couple billion dollars and I can still do the same stuff that I want to do and have my own stuff. At what expense? What is losing $1 billion to have freedom? What is that? It's not when you're a billionaire and you're only losing $2 billion to have $400 million to have freedom. Come on. He gets to post when he wants. He ain't got to worry about nothing. And then on top of that, it shows you how powerful he is. The same people that he talked about, they let him release the platform. So how much do they don't? The same people that talked about Ye, right? We just think about this. The same people that talked about him, he released his album talking about them on their platform. That is crazy to me. Isn't that crazy? Is that not crazy to y'all? The same people that he talked about, he still released his record on a platform and still make money from them. That is just crazy to me. So with the, I'm telling you, and Ye win. Adidas took a picture with Ye because they're probably sitting in a meeting with Ye saying, hey, can you help me? Ye said, nope, I got Yeezy.com. I'm about to release these pods and make millions on you. This is what Ye had a, and I'm sticking up for Ye because all this makes sense. Ye had an interview where he said, hey, I don't want to sell product at $200. They're making me do that. They're making me do that. I want to sell them for this. Y'all get off Ye. He said, I want to sell them for this. I don't want to sell them for $200. And what is he doing right now? He's selling $20 pods. Pause. Why is that such a big thing? Because if you buy a $20 pod, isn't that crazy that I can buy a $20 pod and flip it for $1,000? That helps the community. Boom. Ye is different. Ye bought thousands of acres to build factories to employ people. That Bianca girl was just a designer that graduated a regular college, right? Bianca Sensory. She was just a regular old designer. He gave her a job and just married her to make her a model. He changed her life. We didn't know who Bianca was. Stop. All these designers that he's messing with, no namers. He literally said, hey, I'm Kanye West. Let me take my community and let me flip my community. And that's what Kanye West is doing. And that's why they came out with the article. He's the number one independent artist on Spotify. Nobody can do it. Taylor Swift can't do it. She can't. 100%. Oh, yes, she can. She can buy it. Then why is she doing it? You want to know why she can't do it? Because she has a record deal. That's why she can't. I proved my point. She got a record deal. She can't go against the beast. She needs the beast. Taylor Swift writes her own music. She's one of the greatest producers, one of the greatest singers of all times. Don't ever get it twisted. I'm a Swiftie. Don't ever get it twisted. But she's already with the beast. She can't leave. She's done. Over with. First lady NFL is to the, she submitted to the beast. She's done. There's nothing she can do. We're waiting on these potatoes to be done. The meatloaf is in the oven. Meatloafing. Oh, it's beautiful. Let's take the, let's turn the meatloaf off. I have mashed potatoes I'm doing right here. I don't stick up for Ye. I'm getting to your comments, YouTube, because we're talking about Ye. I just want people to give Ye grace. Is he reckless? 100%. His execution ain't the best. We get that. Everything that boy said he was going to do, he did it. He did it. Is he reckless? Yes. But how are you going to get out these deals? They're not going to let you get out the deal. So what are you going to do? Hey, you're going to write him a letter. Hey, guys, can you get me out this deal? Because I'm trying to do this. You won't let me do it. They won't do it. How are you going to get him out? Oh, hire $300 million worth of lawyers to try to get you out this deal? It don't work like that, buddy. They own you, Kanye West. So all it took for me to say a couple trash words to you, knowing that I really love you, that's why he took the picture with Adidas. Come on. Come on. He's an icon. Don't ever. Y'all need to rewatch that genius. Somebody took his mom's life away and he's autistic. Are we not, is this not real here? His mom was the only thing left. He has a dad. His mom was the only thing left. He was autistic. They say he was an autistic genius. This is, somebody took his mom. The only thing he had left, his wife left him. He's crazy. Like, bro, he said I'm bipolar and I have autism. Like, what are we doing? He's an icon. We've never seen somebody with bipolar and autism be at this high of a level. He's an icon. We got to stop. Nobody's arranging music the way Kanye West is doing it. And he has autism. Usually, when we think of autism and bipolarness and ADHD, we think of that as not a power. That's why he keeps saying, I have superpowers, because it's the truth. Nobody with autism and bipolarness and ADHD is doing what he's doing. You can't do it. You can't. Nobody's going on stage talking about Taylor Swift because you're scared. You're not doing it. This boy's an icon. He's an icon. Turn your phones down if I'm screaming. I get lit. Jay-Z's an icon because he founded him. Jay-Z's the God. Kanye West is an icon. I don't know what you guys think in your brain. When you have bipolarness, autism, and your mom died, you can't move. You ain't doing nothing. Usually that's called a disaster. That's the equation for disaster. What are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing with this? TikTok, what's up? TikTok sending the likes. We're 17,700 likes over here. BeWithCooks.com is real. If you don't go there, then you're fraud. Shout out to my managers in the building. Stucky Pie in the building. Social cues. You know what's funny? You didn't sign up with social cues. You're a loss. Drake told you, I'm going to tell you, your loss. Those companies out there, family too. Those companies, I hope you replay it. Everybody out there, replay it. We came to you door to door. Yeah. But we came to you business to business, gave you free trials. Your loss, we gave you free time. We gave you time and energy. I was taken away from Be What Cooks. We're taken away from family and friends and all that. We gave you free time and you didn't want to sign up. That's how Be What Cooks started. I wasn't doing Be What Cooks. But because y'all didn't want to sign up, that was the fuel to get me started. Stop playing. And then you know what the funny thing is? I'm going to still go to you companies and put you on gas or pass. We win. That's how y'all help me. You help me see the vision, and I'm going to still go back to you and help you. That's what God told me to do. Each one of those companies, because they're all talented. God told me to do that. And we're going to do it through content. Cooking food. We make it mad. We got meatloaf in the oven. I'm going to the content. I'm going to the... you keep saying you're going to go to the... It's just because I'm scared to get to the comments because there's so many over here on YouTube and stuff. I'm about to get in trouble. And I know y'all talking to crap. Oh, he's fake. Oh, he's fraud. I understand the importance of donating. My mom has her foundation, so I got you. 100%. And I'm not going to Bill Clinton your donations. I won't do it. I'm not here for that. See, Bill Clinton showed that he was fraud. See, the problem is we saw it differently. Bill Clinton said he was fraud a long time ago with ML. I don't know if I can say her name on YouTube. I don't want to say her full name and not monetize. But her, ML. We knew he was fraud then. That boy was in the White House. Instead of saving the country, he was saving himself. Literally. Shout out to Bill Clinton out here. Showed him. He was the first OnlyFans. YouTube, come on, stop. I didn't even finish. I didn't even put the NS on it. Stop. I'm trying to monetize. I don't know what I can say these days. All facts. We in the building. Dallas in the house. Family of four is over here. That's nice. Those are great ideas, and you definitely get to where you want 100%. Because I you know why I'm going to get to where I want? Because failure is not real. So even if I fail, I won't even know it's real. I have to keep going. That's it. That's how Be What Cooks is. I wish y'all would see what me and my manager texting each other, trying to figure out the algorithm, staying up till nighttime, posting and watching updates and talking about this and this and brainstorming and thinking of ideas. We're about to be on a jet. Come on. We don't have the time. Go to BeWithCooks.com. This is real life. I just want to be able to document it so you can see it, because I'm going to change your mindset. It's real, bro. I know this doesn't make sense. YouTube is not supposed to. You're supposed to replay it. The reason why I have this on YouTube is because when it happens, we can replay this and I can start chopping it up. And you know how they do it when stuff happens and boom. Come on. This is real life. That's why I say you don't have to have the money. And I'm sorry about the... I thought it was a dollar, I promise you, but I did forget that it is $5. It is $5 the least you can do. If you don't have $5, that's fine. Go on the email list. I'll send you free stuff. Don't worry about it. We're on the road soon. Can you block me, NATO? Can you block me, NATO? B Will got the reserve. So NATO, I'm not gonna block you, bro. You're family. So NATO, okay, NATO, I have to say it because when I went live, you were there. NATO, please don't think this is nothing. So NATO saw a recipe of mine, right? And then they went, because I don't even know what recipe that she or he saw. And they went over there to another live and said, hey, B Will Cooks is doing such and such with your recipes. They stole your recipes. Somebody, a random follower, hit me up in the, I'm giving y'all tea right now. NATO, you're not fraud, NATO. You got the fraud pass for today. You got get out jail free card, you're good. I just got to spill the beans because you're here. You said block you. I'm just trying to make sure everybody know. But I get it though, because some people, my recipes could match somebody else, and I get it. Oh, you stole that, I get it. But the only net I know is, Charles, where your lunch at? That's the only net I know. So anyway, somebody said, hey, such and such talking crap about you on the live. I'm just eating my regular old food. Come to find out, NATO over there yapping. NATO fat headed. Oh, I got a monetize on YouTube, because I will be firing you up right now. NATO over there yapping, saying I took some recipe or something like that. I'm like, bro, I got all this on. Man, y'all don't see the hard work me and my manager do, man. We up, man. Reason why I be posting late is because I'm so busy. I edit late, but we be, bro, this is real. But NATO, but I get it. Again, I'm not fraud, NATO, because what if? You know what I mean? So NATO has valid points. This is no fraud. But again, I still have to validate my, I really don't have to validate my point. At the end of the day, I believe in God, bro. I ain't got, that's my only validation. It is what it is. Some stuff you can't control. If Chris Rock got slapped and he couldn't control it, there's just some things you can't control, bro. Hey, all the replayers, to the replayers. Yeah, there's just some things you can't control. But that's where NATO's coming up. So if y'all see NATO popping up just saying random stuff, that's because we're kind of beefing right now. And the funny thing is, I didn't even start it. Nobody asked NATO to go over there. And why did NATO even come to my page and say I stole recipe? Like, you have to follow me. But I understand with social media. This is social media. You can't. I understand social media's of opinions, and I want to make sure y'all have a safe space to even get your opinions off. So I'm not here to say NATO's wrong. 100%. Oh, so that means you did it. I can't. There's nothing I can do to make you believe anyway. So it is what it is. I don't care. Like, I just don't care. I just want to make sure y'all know who NATO is. That's it. Your mommy or Ralph NATO. Fathead. Y'all remember Ralph NATO used to run for president and never win? That's NATO. And then you ain't got no profile picture. We know you fraud. Hey. We know you fraud. You ain't got no profile picture. Hey. Let's take this meatloaf out. I'm talking about I'm taking recipe. I got these recipes on my dome, cuh. What's up? Ask me a recipe. I'll tell you on my dome. I'm going to Netta. Netta? Netta? Ugly. Okay, I told y'all about the grease. I said, hey, we're going to drain the grease. You probably want to let it sit a little bit. Replayers, what's up? And eventually I'm going to get a better phone once we get these donations up so you can see clearly now. The meatloaf has come. But we're broke. So I told you, my job pays me $2,000 a month. I'm not lying to you. I make $4,000 a month on social media. I'm going to get these donations up, invest in these companies, get affiliate codes and all these different things to make money back in return. I'm going to use, again, you invest to make your money back. That's the byproduct. That's going to be my money and the money from the content. That's it. We just need that initial money. And again, that's why I said I'm going to keep receipts. I just won't spend the receipt is I just won't spend the donation money. I'll just let you see every time it grows. I'll just show. Hey, it's that simple. I literally screenshot a picture of the donation money, put it on my thing just to show you, hey, it's still there. Like, come on. I ain't trying to fraud you. Saint, y'all be out here trying to find the scam. I'm like, dang, you got to trust somebody to actually build trust. We'll do another 5 minutes. It's probably 5 minutes. Yeah, we'll do another 5 minutes. Let's read the comments. Meatloaf and potatoes is on the menu tonight. Really, send me some. Always random with singing music. LOL, so my bad, so. Alright, bro. Hey, friend, love your channel. Definitely my kind of cooking. True. I was going to make a pound cake today, but I had all the stuff to make the pound cake. Look. Like, again, that's why I'm saying that you're stealing recipe. I can do a pound cake on the top of my dome. 3 cups of sugar, 2 butters, 2 room temp sticks of butter, 1 pack of cream cheese. Mix that together. Add you some eggs one at a time. Mix that together. Add you some vanilla extract. Add you a little bit of salt with a teaspoon of baking powder. I can do this in my sleep. I soak It's a code. It's not to sell CDs. I'm not a businessman. I'm a businessman. So let me handle my business. Damn. It's real. I can do this. This is, I don't need a Netta. Who is this? What is this? I don't care about Netta. I just got to let her know. I wanted to go live with her. Be like, oh, let's have a recipe battle. I'll spit them like they're bars. What do you want to do? I do this. Oh. That's just a simple pound cake. Let's do a 7-Up. Come on, man. What? These recipes are nothing. These recipes are too easy. Fried cabbage. Mashed potato. What are we doing? This ain't what... Mashed potatoes? But my secrets hit better. Yo, I can't wait till we get big. Me and my cousin, that's my manager. We're going to... our lingo is crazy. Our lingo is crazy. So we have our potatoes. Let's go ahead and strain this. I think y'all, you know, I think a lot of y'all are excited, but y'all just want to see. And I told y'all I went live earlier on Facebook. I'm just in a mode now to start creating to let y'all see it's real. I just want to, like, when I saw that guy the other day and we interacted with each other for the first time, it got me thinking, I just can't wait to travel so I can just, we can put smiles on each other's face. There's two people that I've met, like we actually met. Some people say, hey, you're B with Cooks, whatever, and they just wave and walk off. But there was two people and they were guys, pause. This is crazy, I did not expect this. We didn't even shake hands, we immediately hugged. I know that sounds corny, but that's when I knew, I was like, yeah, it's time for me to be out here. I've sold cars, so I don't mind meeting new people and stuff like that. It's time for me to touch the world, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? That's all it is. Sometimes, especially with business. With business, when people go through stuff, sometimes it's not even the money. It's just they need to vent. Because they're going through a lot of stuff. The family's tough and they just need somebody to vent to. I'm here. You know what I mean? I know what the gaps are with businesses. People just don't want to talk about it. That's all. I know what the gaps are in business. Sometimes it's not even the money. The money's cool. But it's just somebody to talk to. That's it. That's it, slime.
And how about the way I feel, where I'm gonna go?
Put it back on the stove. Turn your stove off. I'm gonna read the comments. I probably said that a million times and ain't done it. So shout out to all the replayers out there that... you're not here now, so you can't really say nothing because you can fast forward. Shout out to the replayers. Anything you miss, go to YouTube. All my long content will be on YouTube. I will be traveling with Gasser Pass pretty soon. I don't know how soon is, but soon sounds good. Pretty soon. My dad's opening up a restaurant. I got y'all involved in that. You sign up on the email list. I'm shipping out free products like the baking mats. Oh, who cares about the baking mat? Some people do. Seasonings. If you're a company and you want me to do a Gasser Pass on your product to see if it's trash or not. Send your products, but send me enough so I can start sending them out, getting you exposure, getting you real reach. I can get these people to do videos. Everybody wants exposure at the end of the day. Some people don't, but a lot of people do. I just understand with exposure, with a million followers, I'm not making no money. So it's bigger than that. It's actually about the work, and it's about creating the ideas. And I think me and my team, it's just me and my cousin, I think right now we're the best in the game. Call it what it is. Remember, we don't have fame. We're the best in the game. Call it what it is. I don't care what y'all have to say. Me and my cousin are the best in the game. That's my manager. We're the best in the game. I wish I could cuss so bad. Because I'll throw the F word out right now on you, boy. What you talking about? Right? Ooh, the F word sound good right now. The F word, boy. Put some butter in that thing. Oh, my God. Did y'all see that? Yo, that's crazy. That's crazy. It's not cockiness. Deion Sanders said it the best. Don't let my confidence offend nobody. Because at the end of the day, my confidence is for us. You need somebody on the line that's working there. You ever heard of a lobbyist? You need somebody out there on the line in the field for you. I'm out here for all the independents out here that think they need to submit to Kroger's and all these people to get brand deals and all that. Huh, you don't. You just got to build value and put some emotion in this goddamn community. They get you paid, but you don't give back. That's the problem. That's your problem. The problem is you don't want to focus on the people. That's your problem. I'm going to change all that. And I'm not worried about nobody taking our ideas, because by the time you take our ideas, you still got to build the audience. You know what I mean? We already did that work. You got to get over that, posting for no reason. I did that. posting, literally, I wasn't making no money. I was literally spending money on food, spending money on new phones, spending money on all this stuff to make no money. Come on. That's a lot of belief there. Then you got to post every day. I was staying up till 2, 3 in the morning. Remember, Danny D was here. I was cooking live on my media page before I even started Be With Cooks. Danny D was there. Danny D is one of the reasons why I started Be With Cooks. Danny D, she been here. She one of the reasons why I started Be With Cooks. She wanted a reason. Danny D believed in me. My mom, she believed in me. She said a couple words like this. Two people. My manager is one. And then Danny, she's in one of the people that believe me. She said, you really got something with B-Wood Cooks. Or you really got something with that cooking stuff. Those simple words is fruit. That was fuel to the fire. People don't realize it's not even about money. Sometimes it's just verbiage, words. Words. Words is the money. She said, those simple things. Oh, you really got something with B-Wood Cooks. I said, for real? She said, yeah. I said, oh, okay, bet. That was it. Hey, cousin said, hey, man, let's do that B-Wood Cooks. Woot, woot, woot. Oh, for real? Oh, okay, bet. Hey, it be so simple. It ain't got to be money. Nobody gave me no money. Nobody gave me no. It just be the most simple stuff. It be simple. People don't even realize it be simple. When people say, hey, I'm praying for you. Oh, that's a bet. I mean, I got them on my back, too. So I appreciate everybody. Put your little buttermilk in there. This is one of the tricks to one of the greatest mashed potatoes on the planet Earth. Matt's Cooper in the building. What you fixing up? It looks good. I got meatloaf over here. I'm letting sit for a little bit, and then I'm going to drain the grease. And then we're going to add some more sauce on it. It looks beautiful over here. I have mashed potatoes that I just put some butter in there, and I put a little buttercream. Don't let any of this fool you. Free recipes are coming forever. Only time you'll ever see me charge off of recipes is when I'm starting to create my own ideas and stuff like that. And create my own recipes and stuff like that. I'll probably do a subscription, but it'll be something that's containable. Something like $2.99 a month. Because we have such a big community, I don't have to charge y'all a lot of money to make money. You know what I mean? I don't have to kill y'all. People do pop-ups and want to charge y'all $200, $300, $400 for what? Go get you a brand deal or something. Go get you some vendors or something. You ain't got to do all that, cuz. You ain't got to sell no spatula for $60 to try to go get a million. Huh. Just build a real community. You know what I mean? So, yeah, we're going on the road. Another thing, my manager his business is social media. Between me and him, and we're helping these companies and changing their mindset, it's going to be big, man. It's hard for me to stop talking about it. I'm ADHD, and I'm just excited about it, dude. It's so annoying. I know it's annoying. I just can't. You know how you're happy about Christmas? I just can't sleep. I can't. I love this. I can't. I just can't. I don't know what to do. I don't. I can't stop talking about it. I love this. I can't wait till I get an RV or get a... I can't. I can't stop. I can't. Dang. I'm sorry I keep talking about it. I just can't stop. I love this SHIT. I really do. It's not made up, bro. It's not. Remember, I could just keep doing recipes and make money. I don't have to involve you. Trust me, I don't. I could come out with a product and not involve you. Trust me, I can just do pop-ups and just do private events, charge you $1,500 to cook. I can have a sous chef and do Airbnb pop-ups and all that. I could do that all day. You see me cooking in front of you right now. What's the difference? Don't play with me. That's not my passion. That's not my calling. God called me for something bigger. It's big! That's what she said. It's big! Put you some cream cheese in your mashed potatoes there. It's big. I know, I can't stop talking about it. I'm sorry. We got the mashed potatoes. I'm sorry. I promise you, I'm sorry. Replayers, I'm sorry. I know I'm just cooking food. I can't. Dude, when it actually happens, I promise. That's why I say I promise you when it gets to the point I'm going to work. Because I have to work. I don't have time to play. It's just right now I'm so passionate about it. Until it happens, I just don't know what to do. I'm sorry. I feel like a little kid, bro. I'm serious. I'm sorry, guys. I know it's annoying. I'm sorry, dude. Replayers, I'm sorry for not just cooking, showing you all the food. I'm sorry, for real. I know you're just here for food. I'm so passionate about this. I don't know if you've ever seen something like this. Passion. I'm talking about the passion. This blood, sweat, tears. Every time I'm cutting something, my hands hurting. I'm crying. Cried yesterday. It's real. It's real life. You know, when you're an entrepreneur and you fail at multiple businesses or a business before, you have that fear to jump in. You don't get beliefs. People like, you know, people don't believe in you. It's hard for people to believe in you. It's hard. And it's hard to do something when you don't have belief. That's why I say when you have people like Danny D, my cousin, say, oh, you should do this. Hey, let's think of this. Let's do this. Bet. That's why I try to tell people it's not about the money. It's not about the money. It's not. It's not about the money. It's not about the money. Danny D ain't gave me a dime. It's not about the money. It's not. It's not about the money. Pink Himalayan salt. It's not about the money. I'm going to keep saying that. For anybody out there to think it's money, Rich Paul said something genius. Rich Paul said, when I hire people as agents, I don't bring up money because I don't want to use that as a crutch for them not to work hard. Because if they say, well, I don't have enough money, I don't have this, it's not the money. It's not. Some people, I tell you a perfect example. Some people that don't have money, you could just watch my ad for 2 seconds. 2 seconds more than the 5 seconds before skip, because that gets us paid. You already heard my vision. This is real. This ain't no Scottie Pippen. This is Jordan. No Larsa. Put some pepper in there. Come on. And I'm not this annoying in real life. I promise you, I'm really not. I mean, I am. Oh, my God, I am. But not really. Shout out to YouTube, all the replayers. We're going a long time on YouTube. This is great. This is awesome. Put some pepper in there. I don't think I'm gonna make any green beans. I don't have to. I don't care about having the green stuff. I'll put a little bit more. Let me taste it. I don't care about having anything green right now. I should have made grandma's biscuits, but I'll make a pound cake and something else probably next week. Oh, I know what you need. I know what you need, baby. I know what you need, baby. Some garlic powder. That's what you need, baby. That's what bae need right there. And a little bit more pink Himalayan salt. That's what bae need. That's what bae need right there. That's what bae need right there. Come on, bae. Hey, if your mans ain't bringing a plastic plate, is he really a man? Probably not. Plastic plates is where it's at. And if you're not getting them at Dollar Tree, is he really a man? Probably not. Dollar Tree paper plates all the way. Or Winco. I think that's Winco. That's a Winco paper plate. Get your husbands, get your wives to start buying from Winco. They're good. I know that grip is tight. Keep it going. I'm going to keep it up, big dog. Okay. Yeah. Is that wall plaster? Bro, what he doing? We're doing meatloaf, mashed potatoes. I was going to do some green beans, but... You know what? I think next month I'm going to teach you how to make gumbo too. It's really, really easy. It's just y'all don't get the flour part. Y'all don't understand that you're really cooking flour for like 25 to 30 minutes. Seriously. You're seriously cooking flour. All you're doing is taking the fat and the grease from the meat, and then you have your bell peppers and onions and your celery and all that stuff. But you're literally cooking that flour for 25 to 30 minutes, almost 40 minutes sometimes, depending on what kind of heat you got it. A lot of people just don't understand that part. And that's why you can't make gumbo, because gumbo's too easy. It's too easy. It's too easy. Gumbo's one of the easiest things on the planet Earth. It's just like a little soup. But you got to have that roux, because the roux is going to give it the thickness and the color. You know what I mean? I just haven't made a gumbo video. First of all, if I make a gumbo video, it's going to get 1 million views. Like, you already know what it is. Like, let's call it what it is. So I'm going to save that for a good day. That's going to be like if I'm broke or something that month, I'll just release that video, call it a day. Those one of those. Not because I'm doing it. It's just I know that's a thing, you know, gumbo. It don't matter who does it. It's just a thing. Anybody can come out with a gumbo video. But certain people can do gumbo and it's going to be a hit. Like Darius Cooks can do gumbo. One Chop can do gumbo. Make It Happen can do. All these people can do gumbo. Oh my God. Y'all see that? That's a mash. I put cream cheese. The buttermilk's going to give it the tanginess. Where's my plate at? Let's get the meatloaf. God, those... Whoo! Remember, I let that meat. Look. I told you I'm gonna let the meatloaf sit. Then I'll drain the grease out the meatloaf. So I'm gonna drain the grease out the meatloaf. You can actually just pick the meatloaf up and put it on the cookie sheet. But I'm gonna drain the grease out the meatloaf. You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put it on a cookie sheet so I can finish decorating. I said decorating. We said decorating.
Oh, I'm just falling in love.
You see that baking mat? You can use the baking mat for this too. See? I told you the baking mat is really, really good. It's just like parchment paper, but it's infinity. And this brand, you can buy them on Amazon, but this brand to me is the best. The ones on Amazon are cheap, but this one, they don't sell this. Imperial Sugar believed in me when nobody believed in me. Oh my God. Ah! When I had 1,000 followers, they saw me then. So did Hidden Valley and some other companies. I will always be in debt to them. I even said, like, no matter how big I get, hopefully if somebody from them replay this, now you can't take advantage of me. Now, whoa, I got a community. We need stuff. We're broke. It's a lot of poor peoples around. Y'all see that video? But Imperial believed in me when I had nothing. Like when I'm 1,000 followers and getting no views. Hidden Valley, they reached out to me then. They didn't reach out to give me stuff. They just reached out to say, hey, thanks for using Hidden Valley Imperial. And then Imperial's the first big company to send me product to give to you guys. So we always going to support Imperial no matter what. And this is exclusive. They gave me these and they don't even sell them. Only certain content creators got them. But she gave me a pack to give to you guys for free. So we always going to support that brand no matter what. I get it. They're not paying me for it. I know that's dumb. But certain people, sometimes you just got to be real, man. You got to call it what it is. Got to call it what it is. She ain't had to send me that stuff to give to you guys. But she kind of helped me get that vision. You know what I mean? She ain't have to do that. Yeah, they didn't have to send me. They didn't have to send me that. You know what I mean? Or how about this? They didn't have to send us that. They didn't have to find me and 1,000 followers. The hell are you doing watching me at 1,000 followers?
I said I'm just falling in love.
Okay, so we got the ground beef or the deal. I don't even know if this is cooked all the way, but I believe an hour to an hour and 15 minutes. I didn't check the temp. Usually you want to check the temp. It wants to be about 170, 175 on Meatloaf. Check it. Guys, all the replayers, if you make it this far, I apologize for saying thermometer. Or thermostat. I said thermostat. I meant to say thermometer. Get you a kitchen thermometer. There needs to be more brands that get into kitchen gadgets instead of seasonings and all the aprons and cookbooks. There's other stuff out here that people need. Let's start focusing on that stuff. Okay. Ooh, that's hot. Let's see. God. I could just cut it in here, but I just want to. Ah, no. No, I'm going to keep it in there because I don't want it to break. But let me do this, though. Oh, yeah. Nothing else to talk about. Cause I was gonna decorate the outside, but I told you I like mine loose because I don't want to look. Oh my God, dude, y'all are about to go crazy. I like it loose because I want to leave a little bit of pockets in there so I can know the inside is cooked and stuff like that. So I leave mine a little loose, and you want to anyway. My mom used to do it like that, and I see a lot of people on Food Channel do it like that. Because when you pack it, it won't have places to breathe. So it can cook the insides and stuff like that. Oh my God. Who, what are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing here? Hello? What are we doing? Look, mashed potatoes. What are we doing here? All the replayers on YouTube, You could see all the ingredients. I went step by step on the ingredients. TikTok. The inside's cooked, by the way. We went step by step on the ingredients. Me, you know, like me, I like a little sauce on top. You know what I'm saying? That's just me. You could also make a gravy with the grease. If you need to find out about this recipe, go to YouTube. I'm about to get it. Oh my God. Why are you tasting like this? Why? God, look how you could tell it's juicy. You could tell it's juicy. Look, I didn't even have to chew it, bro. It just melt in my mouth. Pause. Oh my God. Look. It's so juicy, bro. Look. It has this texture. Like, the texture is there. You're not worried about it. It's not slimy or nothing. It's just, remember, I leave it loose so it can be juicy. I'd rather have mine juicy and crumbles, or it's still a piece. See? But I'd rather have mine juicy. You see what I'm saying? If you need this recipe, TikTok, go on YouTube if you need this recipe. Oh my God. I haven't ate all day and I'm really hungry. Oh my God, man. Oh my God. I know it seemed like I'm, you know how everybody said their food is good? I promise you, this one is different. This might be the best one I've ever made. Wow. Okay. Dude, I'm not lying. You think I'm playing? Like, everybody exaggerates on their food. If it's not, it don't matter. It's real. I'm even eating the stuff at the bottom. I can make a good. It might be better than my mom's meatloaf. It might be better than my mom's. It, I mean, hey, you ain't got to believe it is what it is. Try that recipe exactly, guys. I made it live. You can actually replay this live. I'm not going to have to replay on TikTok. You can do the replay on YouTube. YouTube, I appreciate everybody in here. I'm going to read your comments. You're mad cute, not going to lie. I appreciate all the compliments and stuff like that. I really do. God, I mean, this might be the best. If you want to throw some blue cheese in here, you want to throw some fresh parsley. I've even seen cilantro in the meatloaf. Throw some cheese in there to be creative. It's just 2 pounds of ground beef with, and you need sticking agents. So you're going to need breadcrumb, your eggs, your milk, onions, bell pepper. If you want to do some jalapeno for a little spice, throw you some seasonings on there, mix it up, put it in the thing, put it in the oven for about, make sure you need moisture too. So if you watch, I actually have a meatloaf video. If you see my meatloaf video, I put wet bread in the meatloaf because it helps you with the wetness and the moisture. So you can just take some bread, everything you have already, in your house. So you could just take some bread pieces, some stale bread or some bread, put some buttermilk in there, probably like half a cup of buttermilk, let it soak, and then take the soaked bread and throw it in your meatloaf. All you're doing is using a sticking agent. You can do that's without eggs. You don't have to put eggs when you're doing it like that. You could just use buttermilk. Buttermilk and some bread. Put it together, let it soak, throw it in your meatloaf so you don't have to use an egg. A lot of people don't like eggs. But eggs are your most traditional ways. Again, I appreciate everybody on YouTube. Y'all are the ones. Y'all were holding it down. We're going in 260, 10. Hey, I messed with that. Kathleen Hurley, what she said? Oh, don't I know that name? I really like those silicone sheets. I use one at a friend's house. They are awesome. Great. Remember, if y'all want any of these products, we're going to get more products. Don't worry about that. Remember, I still got bacon up, that bacon grease. I still have some I got to send to 5 followers. This company sent me some knives. I got to send y'all some knives. You know, I just remember, Gas or Pass is not going to end ever. So it's almost, again, Gas or Pass is really my vision from Undercover Boss and Shark Tank put in one. But I'm going to infuse it with me and my ideas. I used to watch those when I was a kid. Those were my two favorite TV shows. Look at this. You see how juicy that is? Like, that is crazy. You know a good meatloaf, it's stiff, but when you eat it, it melts in your mouth. It's still stiff, pause. It's still stiff. It just, it's so juicy, it's just melting. You know what I mean? And it still has this dryness. That's why people use the rack, so it can dry out and get that firmness. That looks awesome. Cool. I really like those. Yes, can you speak Russian? Sprich. Ave ever von Zamordis. Tu Regina Venus Tatis. Tu Regina Venus Tatis. Ave ever von Zamordis. Make that deep, dark brown roux. I am Russian boy. I need to buy one of those. Yeah, sign up on Be Will Kush. You might can get one for free. I have a little bit left. Oh my goodness, I hate logo. It my B-Day. That's for shouting me out. Max Cooper's B-Day. What's good? Max Cooper in the building. He's making meatloaf and mashed potatoes. I appreciate Fate holding it down. Oh, you know what would be good? If, you know, somebody put grits over here. They didn't put it for the meatloaf. What if you made a good smoked Gouda grits with meatloaf? Like, what if you had a really good meatloaf? Like, say if we made this meatloaf right here, right? We cut our pieces and we pan fry the meatloaf to get like a little, like that pan fry kind of grill kind of texture to the top. Maybe do it in some butter, some herby butter, and then get you a nice bed of grits. Ooh, that's what I'm saying. Like, when I can really create and have time to really focus, I can think of something that might be good. Grits and meatloaf, I bet you it's fire. Especially if you have the right sauce with it. If I make a good gravy sauce with it out of the meatloaf grease. That's, I haven't seen meatloaf and grits. I don't know. But a good smoked Gouda, probably a good, I need something strong. Probably smoked Gouda. Smoked Gouda grits. Put a little heavy cream in there. Salt, pepper. Probably some garlic powder to play with them a little bit. You know, do a little different. I told you I make a meatloaf grilled cheese that's pretty good. So that's probably one thing I'll do Tuesday. I'll take pieces of that and make some grilled cheese out of it. Gumbo is easy. Yeah, gumbo is easy. Please respect the content creator, Fate. No. People ain't got to respect, man. I can't control everybody. I have too many followers, man. I know people ain't going to be... People don't understand the assignment. Some people just... You know, they're out here, man. You know, some people like giving opinions. Some people like getting Twitter fingers. We got to respect them, too. That's a whole culture. So I'm not out here to... I'm not out here to have fun. Especially with YouTube. There's a whole bunch of crazy people out here on YouTube. So anyway, all right, YouTube, we out this mug. I'm gone. Love you. Make sure you comment. TikTok, I'll be here in a little bit. Make sure you comment, like, share, subscribe. We're going to the moon. BeWillCooks.com. Make sure you donate. If you don't donate, that's cool. Sign up on the email list. If you don't sign up on the email list, you're fraud. So make sure you subscribe, send this to your friend, comment, YouTube. I love you. We out.